coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world. It's the award-winning, critically acclaimed Get Up and Go show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from the Palatial Studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
Well, thank you very much, and a happy Tuesday morning to you.
What day is today?
Today is Tuesday. Oh, we got a lot going on today.
Today is a very special day for us.
That's right. It's a very special day for us, as they say. It is 6:07. Mr. Clock, would you do the honors, please?
It's now 6:07 a.m.
6:07 a.m. on the Get Up and Go show. Welcome in and enjoy your day. Happy Tuesday morning to you. Thank you so much for joining in. Of course, I was off yesterday, back in the saddle today, Tuesday, May the 31st. Tough day for me. I'll tell you why in a little bit. Gonna join in now with G and Bonnie.
WPSL. It's 6:10. It's the morning show with G and Bonnie, and Evan has joined us in Studio 3B. Stewart. I guess you call that with his show and tell. Just a game. I haven't heard that since 1929.
Man, I love that song.
Was that Al Wilson?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that was a nice song.
Yeah, it was.
So how you doing, Bubba?
I'm doing good, man. I had a great weekend. I got to hang out with Chef Mark at an event that I did on Saturday. It was a 10-year-old birthday party unlike any 10-year-old birthday party I've ever seen.
Wow. Bonnie, now, Chef Mark, that's
Ellie's Deli.
Ellie's Deli.
And did he make the food for the event, Evan?
Oh, did he make the food, Bonnie? Let me tell you.
How about the big cookie?
Oh.
There should have been plenty of those for the kids.
Man,
they were little kids.
There wasn't a big cookie, but the cake lady, Stacy, made this incredible cake for a 10-year-old.
Oh, I know the cake lady.
Yeah.
Yeah. Boy, you're doing 10-year-old birthday parties now.
I did it with my photo booth, and let me tell you, these people went all out for this 10-year-old. I'm telling you. Unlike any, it was like a quinceañera.
Oh, yeah, I dig it. I had a quinceañera this weekend, and the girl looked like Cinderella.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, the dresses that they wear when they turn to...
Like a princess, just like a little princess?
And I'm so glad I'm not a girl. I got to tell you.
And so am I.
I am. So when you, after doing something like that, you're like, well, how do you even walk in that?
I mean,
how do you sit down in that? And excuse me. I'm sorry. Give me. She changed, though. After about halfway through the thing, she changed into a regular thing, but good Lord, what is it? Has it got wires in it or something?
I don't know. It's just unbelievable.
I'm talking the Cinderella dress with the umbrella. It's like an umbrella.
Oh, my gosh.
Parasol.
It sticks out like 6 feet around you.
And feel like you have a stick in your back or something in the tightness when you got to walk around.
I thought I was like Mary Poppins or something.
You know, I saw a dress in Palm City Goodwill the other day that looked very much like Dorothy's dress from The Wizard of Oz. Yeah. It was kind of like the color of it. You know, it was that old-fashioned type of dress. They had it out on display, and I thought...
It didn't make you think for a second, I think I might want to buy this, did it?
It didn't.
Okay.
No, it didn't at all. And not even, like, you know, if I even had a little girl in my life now. Topanga's all grown up, but yeah.
Is she a real girly girl?
Topanga's kind of girly, yeah.
Girly, yeah.
You know what? I kind of copied her because we went to the mall together one Saturday, and, you know, I kind of envied the way she looked in these jeans that she was trying on. Mm. Those bell-bottom jeans are kind of coming back.
Uh-oh.
So we were in the buckle, and, you know, she comes out looking all, you know, just perfect figure and shape and everything, and so I secretly copied her and went there the following week and got a pair of jeans that.
You go, girl.
Bell bottom.
Okay.
Only she had like that tight little top going too. You know, top that comes above the belly, and I'm not going to be wearing that.
The midriff bulge.
Oh my god.
I can see Evan in bell bottoms. Evan, you wore bell bottoms, didn't you?
I did. I wore Jordache and Sergio Valente.
Oh. Dude, I mean, and see, the thing is, you're talking jeans.
Yeah.
See, and then in those days, the name was always on the butt pocket.
That's right. Yeah. The Sergio Valente had the V on the butt pocket.
I like Sergio's jeans. It was a nice dark blue, too. Mm-hmm. And it had that and the Calvin. Do you remember Brooke Shields, the logo for the Calvin Klein's commercials back in the day?
I don't remember the logo, but I do remember Brooke Shields.
Do you remember the catchphrase? Or the slogan.
No, I don't.
It was very racy because Brooke Shields was, what, a teenager? I think she was like maybe a tween.
Yeah.
The slogan was, nothing comes between me and my Calvins.
Calvins.
Ooh.
Can you believe that? Nothing comes between me and my Calvins?
That is a little bit racy.
Well, heck yeah.
Time.
Wow.
It be that racy, maybe considered like today.
I remember that like it was yesterday. But, yeah, in those days, you had to, I mean, if you didn't wear designer jeans, you certainly were not in style.
No, not at all.
You couldn't go to Walmart or Kmart. Was Walmart even around?
It was Kmart.
Around. You couldn't go there and get no Bobo jeans.
No. I'm glad I don't live in that day anymore where, all the girls had to have.
Oh, you had to style.
You had to have Jordache jeans.
Or some name. Some name had to be on your butt.
Like a brand name. And, yeah, you feel sorry for the kids maybe going to school that maybe their parents can't afford all that brand name stuff. And
they're the ones that had the no names. But Evan, what just blows my mind now are the jeans that has all the holes in them.
Oh, yeah. Edward Scissorhands jeans.
And they cost more than the ones that don't have holes.
I know.
Be kidding me.
That's the style.
Make my own holes in my own jeans. Just start, get some scissors out and start.
You can go to Goodwill and buy a $3 pair of jeans, get a pair of scissors, cut slices in them, and nobody's going to know.
Yeah, they will, because it's an entirely different way they cut them. But who'd have thunk that, Evan? Come on.
Now. I know.
And I think those jeans are so sexy. Not to brag or anything, but those ones look sexy on me when I got, the knees knocking out.
The knees or the right up here above the thigh, a little cut right there.
That little slit just to leave a little something to the imagination.
Boy, we see styles come and go. And that's what it is. It's leaving a little to the imagination.
It is.
I mean, just to, you can't show too much because then it just spoils the whole thing.
You know what? Dad bods are looking like they're going to be trendy this summer once again. You know that Kevin James dad bod?
Oh.
I think he has the perfect one if you want to describe someone.
And there's granny. I don't think they call them granny jeans for girls, but the high-waisted jeans now. They come up higher than they used to. That's in again. I'm like, that's ugly.
Oh,
I would make a slogan for that. Jeans that fit a real woman.
Oh,
I like that.
Women that have real figure. But you know what, Bonnie? Funny you mention that. There's more commercials now with women that are regular-shaped women. Not these perfect Barbie doll little skinny little things anymore. Uh-uh. They're using real women on commercials now.
Old Navy has a commercial
that I
love. All of the
they got some
size
big girls on that commercial.
Mm-hmm.
And they're working it, too. They're doing that little dance. Yeah.
Yeah, I love it. I love it.
Yep.
It's in now.
I think they're sexy.
That's in now.
Big beautiful women.
What they used to call it? Big and beautiful. Or something. Bold and beautiful, big and something. Whatever.
And, we've been watching reruns of The Love Boat once in a while, and I'll look back at these women, they'll have Charlie's Angels and those kind of girls on the show. And, yeah, it was different back in the day because what was in was your stick, paper-thin figure.
Being thin was
being
in.
A thin.
Made girls stop eating. What was that disease that a lot of girls started having?
Anorexia.
Yeah, made girls think that that was how America, that's how a girl should look. What do you mean how a girl should look? Who says?
I mean, kind of like a robust kind of figure on a lady. And
full figure works.
Rubenesque is what we call it.
Oh, that's what it is?
Rubenesque.
Bodacious.
Yes, a good one. Bodacious.
Yep. The boys.
BBW, big, beautiful woman.
Yeah, but you know what Belle Biv DeVoe said about that.
What? Who's that?
The group that spawned off of New Edition. And when they did that song called Poison.
Oh, that's nice. Well, you do that nicely.
The saying was, never trust a big butt and a smile.
Oh, yeah? I never knew. It is 6:17. Good morning. A Jupiter Middle School student competing in Scripps National Spelling Bee. And we hear more from WPTV Stephanie Susskind.
The all-star speller from Jupiter Middle School will compete on the big stage at the Scripps National Spelling Bee.
National Spelling Bee Finals.
That's always been my dream.
She says she loves learning new words and their meaning. Her favorite word to spell?
Bouillabaisse, which is like a French like stew of seafood. It's B-O-U-I-L-L-A-B-A-I-S-S-E.
A perfect score on a third grade spelling test sparked her spelling bee bug. She won a school bee this year and then the regional competition.
It's really exciting, but also nerve-wracking, and you learn how to be calm under pressure.
She's very detail-oriented, and she is dedicated, and she is a straight-A student across the board. And what I really like about Varshita is that she's very humble.
Christine McAlexander is Varshita's English teacher and helped her establish a spelling bee club at the school.
After I got to know her and I saw how passionate she was about the club and how dedicated she was to studying, I couldn't say no.
But now it's time for the big bee.
So all the spellers know is that all of the words come from the dictionary, but they're not studying in a book like this anymore. Now it's all online.
Crystalloblast.
C-R-Y-S-T.
Varshita uses a website called Spell Pundit to study 3 to 4 hours a day and 5 to 6 on the weekends.
First, like, read over each word, and then I, like, test myself, and then I, like, retest myself on the ones that I got wrong. And then I also study root words, and I write, like, flashcards and sticky notes and hang them up on my wall.
She's ready to take on the best of the best.
Hoping for a word that I know.
And leave the competition buzzing behind her. Stephanie Susskind, WPTV, News Channel 5.
A 10-year-old Florida fifth grade student has been arrested after making a school threat. Sheriff's officials said investigators learned of the threats made by the boy on Saturday and arrested him. Lee County Sheriff Carmine Marcino said in a social media post, "The student's behavior is sickening, especially after that recent tragedy in Uvalde, Texas," the sheriff said. Marcino said that making sure our children are safe is paramount. According to the sheriff, investigators learned of a threatening text message sent by the boy who attended Patriot Elementary School in Cape Coral, which is near Fort Myers on Florida's Gulf Coast. And it should have been the first day of a joyous week for Robb Elementary School students, the start of summer break. Instead, on Monday, the first two of 19 children slain inside a classroom were being remembered at funeral visitations. The gathering for 10-year-old Armory Joe Garza was at Hillcrest Memorial Funeral Home in Uvalde, Texas, directly across from the grade school where the children, along with two teachers, were shot to death on Tuesday before the gunman himself was killed. Visitation for another 10-year-old, Mate Rodriguez, was at another funeral home. More visitations, funerals, and burials will follow over the next 2.5 weeks, one after another after another. Residents of Martin County remembered and honored our fallen service members during a Memorial Day parade held Monday morning in Stewart. Here's WPTV's John Shaman. He was there.
Today's a day of remembrance, reflection, and honor to those who lost their lives in service to this country. In 1971, last Monday in May became the official national holiday.
Too many people fall into this pattern of sales and barbecues and so on and so forth without recognizing the significance of the day.
My dad was World War One. He was Navy, and he's the one that's in my heart and my mind all day.
I'd like to honor some local soldiers who served and died for this great nation. Navy SEAL Special Ops Chief Aaron Carson Vaughn, Afghanistan, August 6, 2011. Remember, reflect, and honor.
Time is 6:23 now, and we will have weather and traffic together for you next.
Time for a look at sports this morning. Arizona Cardinals cornerback Jeff Gladney was killed in a car accident early Monday morning. The Cardinals released a statement Monday afternoon also confirming Gladney's death. We are devastated to learn of Jeff Gladney's passing. Our hearts go out to his family, friends, and all who are mourning this tremendous loss. The crash took place around 2:28 a.m. Monday, according to the Dallas County Sheriff's Department. A white vehicle was overturned when officers arrived. Dallas Fire Rescue confirmed two people, a male and a female, were dead. According to the Dallas County Sheriff's Department, the crash involved two vehicles. According to preliminary information, the white vehicle was speeding and clipped the vehicle in front of it, losing control before hitting a beam on Woodall Rogers Freeway in Dallas. The two people in the other vehicle were not injured. Investigators will release the names of the two people who died in the accident once the medical examiner makes positive identification of the bodies and notifies next of kin. Time now is 6:24. We'll have a look at traffic and weather coming up next.
And I invite you to tune into the Casey Ingram Show at my new time, Wednesdays at 10 a.m. Hear from community leaders, learn about some of our great nonprofit organizations, get the latest updates from our elected officials, and meet the candidates. Even rock and roll legends have joined the show from time to time. I'm conservative but not divisive, bringing you the talk of the community. It is a fun and interesting hour beginning at 10 a.m. every Wednesday on WSTU AM 1450 and Facebook Live at the Casey Ingram Show.
It is 6:25 on the Get Up and Go show this morning. Let's have a first look at traffic out the door as you're heading to get to work by 7 a.m. Florida Turnpike and I-95 from Fort Pierce all the way down to Jupiter is looking real good. No delays. Side streets are looking good. That's your latest look at traffic. 73 degrees right now under partly cloudy skies here on the Treasure Coast. This weather report brought to you by Sailfish Roofing, a community roofing company you can trust for repairs or replacing a roof. Give them a call, 772-263-ROOF. Here's Katya Hall with WPTV.
Your WPTV First Alert forecast calls for temperatures this morning in the low 70s with some spotty showers moving in from off the Atlantic. This afternoon, highs in the mid to upper 80s with scattered showers and storms. Some of those inland storms could be on the strong to severe side. Overnight, temperatures down to the 70s under partly cloudy skies and a few spotty showers into the overnight hours. Tomorrow, highs in the mid to upper 80s, scattered rain near the coast the early afternoon, then rain moving west towards the lake by the late afternoon hours. Thursday and Friday, highs in the mid to upper 80s with those afternoon to evening showers and storms.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
Are you an entrepreneur or business owner along the Treasure Coast? Well, then you should be tuning in to Small Biz Florida from the Florida Small Business Development Center at Indian River State College. Hi, I'm Tom Kindred, your host for Small Biz Florida. Entrepreneurs and business owners will learn how the Florida SBDC and IRSC can help you start, grow, and accelerate your business.
Monday mornings at 11 on WSTU 1450 and worldwide on WPSLTV.com.
The professionals at Mark Breckville Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses, schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Hi there, I'm WPTV's Megan McRoberts, and I've been reporting on the Treasure Coast for years, long enough to know that this place is special.
Same here, Megan. I'm WPTV's Derek Lowe, and I grew up on the Treasure Coast. So take it from me, a lot has changed around here.
We're bringing you what's happening and why it matters. I'm WPTV's John Shainman, and there are so many impactful stories here, it makes you feel good about where you live.
WPTV Treasure Coast News every Saturday at 7 p.m.
and on WPSL and WSTU Sunday morning at 11.
The Slim Body Laser Spa. The wait is over.
What are you waiting for? Call the Slim Body Laser Spa in Stuart today and start losing inches today. That's right. Lose belly fat, your double chin, flabby thighs, upper arm fat. Well, you get the picture. In a short series of laser-assisted weight loss treatments, you can lose inches of unwanted fat. Call 223-5885.
The Slim Body Laser Spa. The wait is over.
Lose weight. Feel great and look fantastic with a little help from Dr. Fred J. Rezacker of Slim Body Laser Spa, East Ocean Boulevard in Stuart. And they're online. Visit their website, slimbodylaser.com. In a few short treatments, you'll see results. Lose 3, 6, even 9 inches of unwanted belly fat. The wait is over. Call today, 223-5885. That's 223-5885.
The Slim Body Laser Spa. The wait is over.
Do you have a suggestion for the show? Send us an email, WSTUmorningshow@gmail.com. And now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
Time now is 6:30 on the Get Up and Go show. We hope everybody enjoyed their holiday weekend. I was a little upset over the holiday weekend, and I'll tell you why. I was sitting out front in my driveway yesterday, and all of a sudden, I'm hearing fireworks going off. I'm like, why in the name, why is somebody setting off fireworks? It's not a day to celebrate and party and drink beer and grill hot dogs and things like that. It's a day that we remember those people that that gave their lives for us. I just couldn't fathom and understand why, and it was just like two blocks away from my house. Why in God's name was somebody, why would you set off fireworks? I don't know. I just simply don't know. Anyway, now that I got that off my chest, let's do some viral videos. So there's a guy on TikTok named Sydney Raz, who's been racking up hits with his, quote, things I didn't know until I was in my 30s videos. Now, he learned the best way to button a shirt is from the button up. He says a costume designer taught him that one. And he also learned you should store brooms upside down because that keeps the bristles straight. And this is a word everyone gets wrong. It's not wheelbarrow, like shooting fish in a barrel. It's wheelbarrow, as an O-W at the end. So here's the first video of him illustrating how to button a shirt. Listen.
Here's something I wish I knew before I was in my 30s.
The best way to button a shirt is from the bottom.
Button. Button.
Button.
Button.
Button.
He was like completely amazed.
That's all buttoned correctly.
He was just completely amazed that his shirt was buttoned correctly. Now, here's another video from him about mistreating your broom. Listen.
Here's something I didn't know until I was in my 30s.
You're supposed to store a broom upside down? Hanging the broom keeps the ends nice and straight. If you have nowhere to hang your broom, you can just flip the broom upside down and lean it in a corner on its handle.
Well, there you go. That's a little lesson learned about the way you're supposed to store your broom. And lastly, here's the one about wheelbarrow. Listen in.
Here's something I didn't know before I was in my 30s. The real name of this tool. Wheelbarrow or wheelbarrel? Wheelbarrel is not technically a word, but you will hear some people say it this way. I'm some people. Wheelbarrow. Wheelbarrow. Here's something I didn't know before I was in my 30s.
Yeah, wheelbarrow. Wheelbarrow. B-A-R-R-O-W is the proper spelling and enunciation. And here's another video. I'll just read the text about it because I can't play the video because it's just music. So it's a guy who ate three of the world's hottest peppers in 8 seconds. Now, Carolina Reapers are the world's hottest peppers, and a guy in California recently set a world record by eating three of them in 8.72 seconds. Even more impressive, his first attempt was disqualified, so he had to do it all over again. And that was the winning time. The previous record was 9.72 seconds. So, yeah, I would say so. Now, there was a story about a week ago about, you know, the guy who ate the Reapers. And there are four serious side effects if you're planning on doing this. So, heed on the side of caution. Side effect number one, stomach pain. Anything from mild discomfort to being doubled over in agony, and it can last several hours. Several hours. Side effect number two, you could have seizures. It's such a shock to your system that it's fairly common for people to hyperventilate, and in bad cases, it can even cause major seizures. Side effect number three, a hole in your esophagus. The chili itself won't burn a hole, but there was a guy 2 years ago who ate a burger with a ghost pepper puree on it, and all the coughing and puking he did tore a 1-inch hole in his throat. And side effect number four is anaphylactic shock and even death. About 10 years ago, a 33-year-old guy in England ate a bunch of homemade hot sauce, and he basically OD'd on capsaicin, the compound that makes the peppers so spicy. It caused his body to release too many histamines, which put him into anaphylactic shock, and he died in the middle of the night from heart failure. So if you're having any kind of thoughts about eating this Carolina Reaper pepper, heed on the side of caution and think twice before you do. You might want to have paramedics standing by, is all I can tell you. It is rather dangerous. Did you know, according to a poll of 6,000 Americans, 30% do not separate the whites and colors while doing the laundry? Now, we were talking about this last week with G and Bonnie, and I throw all my clothes into one load. It saves on water, and it saves on time. And I've never had an issue with colors running on whites. Did you know a first day typically happens more on Wednesdays than any other day? Yes, on Wednesdays. Did you know 16% now claim that they've seen an alien? 16% of people have claimed that they've seen an alien. Did you know, according to a recent survey, 85% of people sing in the car, but 70% of people say they only do it when they're alone? I'll have to think about that one. Next time I'm riding with my wife, I'll have to take note she sings in the vehicle. Did you know the Canadian Medical Association says it's 300% more likely that cyclists who don't wear helmets will suffer a fatal head injury? So when you're riding a bike next time, make sure and have a helmet on. Yes, I should be one to talk because I don't wear a helmet either, but I should start doing that. Did you know folks who skip breakfast are more attracted to images of high-calorie grub and consume 20% more calories? Yes, 20% more calories on average at lunch than those who eat in the morning. And did you know, according to Parents Magazine, parents spend anywhere between 10 to 40 hours a week driving their kids around? Yeah. Good morning. You're on the radio.
Good morning. Yes, sometimes I sing in the car with you.
Oh, you do? Okay. I never noticed it.
I don't do it very loudly. Now, when I'm by myself in my own truck, that's a whole different story.
Yeah, you're probably singing at the top of your lungs when nobody else is in your vehicle.
Pretty much.
Windows up or windows down when you're singing away?
Up.
It's up?
Too hot.
Oh, okay. All right. Hey, I just read something, and I wanted your opinion about it. Let me find it here. Where is it? Skip breakfast. Corny parent. Okay. So I said, did you know, according to Parents Magazine, parents spend anywhere between 10 to 40 hours a week driving kids around.
I can believe that.
Did we do that a lot with Gavin?
I'd say not so much. I mean, we spent a bit of time driving him when he was doing things, but especially with the older kids and with working schedules and
baseball
and things like that, until they could drive themselves. Yes, we spent a lot of time driving kids around.
Yeah, sometimes I felt like we needed to put the taxi sign on top of the vehicle.
No.
You know how that works. Anyway,
absolutely.
By the way, good luck in your new official position today.
Thank you.
Yes, my wife got a raise and a promotion, and it wasn't a raise right out the door either. Today starts her official venture as most of you know, she's been a school teacher for eons, and now she's officially an assistant administrator.
Correct.
Yes, you're out of the classroom, and now you will deal with parents face to face.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll still be dealing with students too, so.
Yeah. So anyway, congratulations and good luck.
Thanks.
All right, kiddo. I'll talk to you later. I got to run. I got things I have to do. I do have a radio show to do.
Okay. Love you.
Love you, too. Have a great day. Time now is 6:41. We'll take a short pause. And when we come back, we'll join back in with G and Bonnie.
Insurance Group. We are a local independent insurance agency located right here on the Treasure Coast. I've been a resident here for 34 years and have helped thousands of clients with their insurance planning needs. We specialize in life, health, and Medicare insurance planning. Don't travel the road alone. Let us be your guide. We are the Owen Insurance Group. Contact us today at 772-210-1020 or visit our website at oweninsurancegroup.net.
Sailfish Roofing is a locally owned company that, above all, offers honesty and integrity in everything they do.
You can trust Sailfish Roofing to use quality materials and workmanship designed to give you peace of mind. Whether you're doing a re-roof, repair, or replacing an existing roof, Sailfish Roofing is a community roofing company you can trust. Call 772-263-ROOF.
Blush Color and Extension Bar, new to downtown Stewart on Albany Avenue and Ocean Boulevard, offering all services including color, cuts, blowouts, keratin, and extensions. Our stylists have years of experience, are masters of their craft. Call us today for an appointment, 772-872-6087. 772-872-6087. Blush Color and Extension Bar.
In retirement, it's all about income, not spending down your principal. And anyone who tells you otherwise simply does not understand proper retirement planning. Hi, I'm Michael Burley of P Capital Management, inviting you to tune in to the Retirement Income Program. Powerful truths that you must know and understand so you may live the retirement you deserve. The key to retirement success is income.
Tune in to the Retirement Income Program right here every Monday morning at 11.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy from St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We needed more space, so we had to move, but only right across the parking lot next to Subway. We're celebrating our move and new store with a huge sale. 25% off all jewelry, 30% off all Citizen watches, and 75% off all Invicta watches, including special orders. Just mention you heard it right here on WPSL or WSTU, and get the coolest T-shirt or keychain free while supplies last. And it might be the best time to sell, since gold has reached an all-time high, and we're paying more than ever for your scrap gold jewelry and your fine jewelry, as well as all of your coins and bullion products. St. Lucie Jewelry is the largest buyer of jewelry and coins since 1994, with two locations, one in St. Lucie West and one on the corner of Walton Road and US 1. Google us, check out our reviews, and come see us last.
For more than 30 years, European Kitchen and Bath has been providing the highest quality kitchen and bath products to their customers on the Treasure Coast. Designer fixtures and quality products at affordable prices. So whatever you need, a new sink and faucet to upgrade your current kitchen or bath, or if you're planning a full 100% makeover, European Kitchen and Bath will help you from start to finish. European Kitchen and Bath, serving the entire Treasure Coast. Visit their website, EuropeanSink.com.
A deadline is approaching for funding for certain USDA partnerships. That's coming up on This Land of Ours.
Farmers, produce safety inspections are here. Prepare your farm with an on-farm readiness review. The Florida Department of Agriculture and Consumer Services and the University of Florida are partnering to provide this on-site preparation service for free. Our team of produce safety experts offer individualized support to make sure your operation meets the regulatory requirements. Contact us to help prepare your farm today. Request your free visit at www.fdacs.gov/OFRR. That's www.fdacs.gov/OFRR.
Peanut producers, fine-tune your farming operation with information gained at the 23rd Annual Southern Peanut Growers Conference, set for July 21 through 23 at Edgewater Beach Resort in Panama City Beach, Florida. The three-day event provides farmers with information about peanut production, legislative issues, marketing, and promotions. The conference is presented by the Southern Peanut Farmers Federation. Visit southernpeanutfarmers.org for more information.
The U.S. Department of Agriculture reminds potential partners that the deadline to apply for the second round of funding through the new Partnerships for Climate Smart Commodities is on Friday, June 10th. The funding pool includes proposals from $250,000 to $5 million that emphasize the enrollment of small and or underserved producers or monitoring, reporting, and verification activities developed at minority-serving institutions. The Partnerships for Climate Smart Commodities opportunity provides up to $1 billion for pilot projects that create market opportunities for commodities produced using climate smart practices. Through the program, USDA will finance partnerships to support the production and marketing of climate smart commodities via a set of pilot projects lasting 1 to 5 years. For more information or to apply, head to the USDA website. I'm Sabrina Halverson for the Southeast AgNet.
You're listening to the Get Up and Go Show with Evan and Bonnie on Martin County's Heritage Station, AM 1450 WSTU. Now let's get back to the program with Evan and Bonnie.
From deep inside Earth's most inaccessible places comes the most treasured gift on Earth. Don't give her diamonds or gold. This year, fill up her tank with gasoline. Millions of years in the making, and this precious commodity will pump her with desire. Show her you love her by topping off her tank with this precious clear fluid with dazzling amber glow. Ignite her passion and fuel her love. De Beers Premium Gasolines.
6:47 right now is the time on the Get Up and Go Show. We're going to join back in with G and Bonnie at this time.
See us last.
Phone always makes me feel stupid. This guy calls me up the other day. It's the wrong number. Guy's off by one number, which is usually the case, but they never know that. So I always pretend like they're off by seven. That's more fun. Is this 213-3125? No. This is 998-7999. What the hell's wrong with you? What are you, drunk? You're drunk, aren't you? Guy won't try again for like an hour. Oh, man. I wasn't even close. Honey, you dial. I think I had the phone upside down. I hate when you tell them it's the wrong number, so they say, are you sure? And how do you talk to these people? I don't know. I'm pretty sure. Well, let me take a look around. Well, I'm in the wrong house.
Let me tell you something. My favorite question when I go to a restaurant is when a waiter asks me, ma'am, do you have any food sensitivities? I can't laugh hard enough. Like, no, boo-boo. No, I don't have zero sensitivities to anything ever. Because I'm Generation X. Yeah, I'm Gen X, man. I grew up playing on scorching hot metal monkey bars in the middle of summer. And when I fell, it wasn't onto foam or mulch. I fell onto a dead hobo. Yes, I grew up swimming in the LA River. It's not a river, it's a sewer. And back in the day, everyone got bullied. Everyone got bullied. And then when you went home and told your parents about it, they would bully you for not standing up for yourself.
Ain't that the truth?
Mm-hmm.
Bonnie, a situation at McDonald's over the weekend. Oh, boy, here we go.
Oh, really? What happened?
Not that they didn't have shakes.
Okay.
Not that the shake machine was down. And
the ice cream was cold. And everything was good.
Not that the pies were so old they were dried up and it was like glue.
Have you ever gotten a pie like
Heck
that?
Heck yeah.
Yes.
Many times. Ever. The pie is so old, the filling will stick to your mouth is stuck closed with the filling itself. But I pull up to a McDonald's and nobody takes my order. I'm at a drive-thru.
Yeah.
Nobody says nothing. I'm there a good 3 minutes. Mm-hmm. I gave them at least 3 minutes.
Oh, my gosh.
So I pulled to the next window, Evan. I mean, mm-hmm. where I'm actually supposed to pay.
Mm-hmm.
And there's nobody there. So I'm like, well, what the heck's going on here? So I go to the third window. Well, the second window where you actually get your food. There's a manager standing there on the phone. She looks at me briefly, but she's assuming – oh, they're going to get his order in a minute, whatever. They probably took care of business. I said, ma'am, nobody took my order. She makes a movement with her finger to the girl that's near her.
Uh-huh.
The girl comes over to me with the headphones in her ear. I said, nobody took my order. She said, oh, I was busy with another customer. What are you talking about, busy with another customer? Isn't your job to be at that first booth so that when I pull up, you say, can I help you, please?
Mm-hmm.
Busy. So I said, well, here's what I want. So and so, so on. She says, you're going to have to pull around again. I can't take your order.
Oh, no, she didn't.
Evan, I said, no, I'm not. See ya. What the heck is wrong with these people?
Pull around again.
She wanted me to get out of the drive-thru, go back around the building and come through again because she wasn't at her station.
No way would I have the patience for that.
I didn't. I'd left.
I would have nothing to do with that.
But it reminds me of this. I mean, a man, there's been a lot of issues with staffing shortages during the pandemic.
Mm-hmm.
But for this one Burger King, it wasn't just a shortage. It was a full-on outage. A guy walked into the Burger King in Pittsburgh Friday. No one was there. He went through the drive-thru, then walked inside, and even opened the door to the kitchen. The whole place completely empty. This was in the afternoon.
Ghost town.
The local news caught wind of it and say that there was one person that showed up to work that day, and when they saw they weren't alone, when they saw they were alone, they quit on the spot, apparently without locking the door on their way out. So a manager eventually showed up to lock the place until it could be staffed. A Burger King rep is downplaying the problem. They say, the shift leader had to leave due to a family emergency. Y'all are Burger King. You're a major corporation restaurant. What? That's the excuse you're giving? Somebody had an emergency and had to close. Burger King, you closed the store because there's an emergency? Somebody had to leave?
They can't get enough employees in a big city like Pittsburgh, and nobody come to work that day?
Bonnie, it's out of control. Local officials say it might be a sign of the times. A lot of people left the workforce during the pandemic, and businesses will have to adapt. But I just can't imagine a Burger King or a chain restaurant like that putting up with this kind of nonsense from their franchise.
Not good at all. You know what that's called?
Say it again, Evan. You broke up.
It's a huge problem, otherwise known as a whopper of a problem.
Showed up to this Burger King on Noblestown Road, and there is nobody in here. Nobody in here. Went to the drive-thru, nothing. Anybody here? Hello?
He might as well went back there and make him a whopper, like Evan's saying.
You know, it's hard finding employees. True story. You know, remember that Sunday that I was off? Remember I was off here a few days, and then I was off from my other job, too, on a Sunday.
Right.
So I was at home. Because I didn't show up that day, the place had to close down on Sunday.
You were the only employee?
I would have probably been maybe me and an esthetician there.
Okay.
And the esthetician, because I didn't show up, I would have been the only massage therapist. And because I didn't show up, she would have been the only esthetician there.
Wow.
So they just closed the place down one Sunday. Can't get enough employees.
Wow.
Want to work the certain shifts.
It's just a mess, man. It really is.
At 6:54, I'm Bonnie with a look at news. Thousands of flights across the U.S. were canceled this holiday weekend, causing chaos and major headaches for air travelers. There were a few cancellations at Palm Beach International Airport, but at Fort Lauderdale and Miami, more than 100 flights were scrubbed, leaving many passengers stranded. For the most part, it was business as usual at PBIA on Monday for those who decided to travel for the holiday. This one from TC Palm this morning, where county fire crews worked overnight on Sunday to battle an approximately 40-acre brush fire near the 4700th block of Indrio Road, according to Daniel Mickles, battalion chief of the St. Lucie County Fire District. At least 4 brush fire trucks responded to the area Sunday afternoon and worked until early Monday extinguishing the blaze. It was just one of 15 brush fires in St. Lucie County over a 2-day span as hot and dry conditions increased the threat of fires. According to Brenda Stokes, spokesperson for the St. Lucie County Fire District, the fire was fully contained as of Monday afternoon, but the Okeechobee District of the Florida Forest Service was still working to put out several remaining hot spots or sporadic areas across the land that were slowly burning, according to Mickles. The FDA and CDC are investigating a hepatitis A outbreak possibly linked to organic strawberries. According to the agencies, the outbreak could be connected to 2 brands of the fruit that were sold at several retailers in the U.S. and Canada. They say Fresh Campo and Heb-branded strawberries purchased between March 5 and April 25 should not be consumed. The strawberries were past their shelf life and sold at retailers nationwide, including Walmart, Aldi, Kroger, Safeway, Trader Joe's, Sprouts Farmers Market, Heb, Wise Markets, and Winco Foods. There have been 15 cases reported in California, 1 case each in Minnesota and North Dakota. At least 17 illnesses and 12 hospitalizations have been recorded so far. On our roadways, everything is up to speed on this Tuesday morning. We have no traffic accidents to report, and that's always good news. Call when you see traffic right here at 340-1590.
Congregation Eitz Chaim.
your welcoming, inclusive, spiritual, and joyful Jewish home in Port St. Lucie. We welcome you to renew your inner Jew and join us. We are Reformed Jewish with a renewal flair. We are multi-generational. We are welcoming to all. Come join us for a Friday night at 7:30 p.m. for our Kabbalat Shabbat services, or Stolen Moments on Saturday morning where we discuss the Parsha of the week at 9:30 a.m. Shabbat morning services follow Stolen Moments, usually at around 10:30 a.m. Our address is 540 Northwest University, across from Met Stadium, and we are in Suite 102. Again, that's 540 Northwest University, Suite 102. Please join us for Friday nights at 7:30 p.m. or Shabbat morning starting at 9:30 a.m. for Stolen Moments. Congregation Eitz Chaim.
This is Chief Gene Saunders, founder and CEO of Project Lifesaver International, and your host for Deploying High. Deploying High is our weekly podcast and radio program dedicated to bringing you interesting conversation from first responders, community leaders, and sometimes even some Hollywood celebrities sharing real-life stories about what gives their lives purpose and meaning. So please join me on Deploying High Sunday mornings at 11:30, following WPTV Treasure Coast News at 11 a.m.
With any business, the most valuable asset are the people and the teams, no matter how small or large the organization. Hi, I'm Catherine Culhane, Associate Director for the Florida SBDC at Indian River State College. Let us help your organization turbocharge your team. As a certified driving forces analyst, I will help management work more effectively with your people, increase and improve communication, reduce conflict and stress, better understand strengths and weaknesses so that your people are properly aligned in their jobs. Hire. Let the Florida SBDC at IRSC transform your company using a customized assessment system, knowledge, and resources. Grow and accelerate your organization by turbocharging your team. To get started, contact the Florida SBDC at IRSC.
For confidential one-on-one business consulting at no cost, contact the Florida SBDC at IRSC at 336-6285. Online at irscbiz.com.
Coming up on 7 a.m. right here at WSGU Stewart, where Martin County's Heritage Station. The news is coming up next, and then we'll have hour number two for me and you right here on the Get Up and Go Show. Don't go anywhere.
Talking about the others gunned down in a classroom a week ago. 19 kids, two teachers murdered in an elementary school. The mayor, Don McLaughlin, wants torn down, telling KENS-TV,
I would never expect a child to have to ever walk in those doors ever and ever again.
The Justice Department is investigating the law enforcement response. The gunman was in the school for more than an hour before he was finally killed. The massacre prompted President Biden and other Democrats to push again for stricter gun laws. And Fox's Jackie Heinrich at the White House says,
there's some hope for a bipartisan gun control agreement in Congress, encouraged by a push from Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell to Texas Senator John Cornyn to find common ground with Democrats. The administration increasingly defensive over pressure for Biden to act unilaterally, refusing refusing some network requests for officials to appear on Sunday shows, saying it's on Congress to act. Biden said his executive powers have limits.
The president also says he has a plan to fight inflation, detailing it in a Wall Street Journal op-ed before a meeting today with Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell.
This meeting is going to be interesting timing-wise because we've got the Friday jobs report. That's going to be for the month of May. Now, this is the nation continues to deal with record high inflation and a labor shortage, which is forcing many pools, restaurants, summer camps to cut their hours of operation.
Fox Business Network Cheryl Cassoni, the price of oil surging up $3, which could lead to more record high gas prices after Europe punished Russia again for invading Ukraine.
A ban on almost 90% of all Russian oil imports by the end of the year.
European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen, as Russian forces keep bombarding areas of eastern Ukraine, two soldiers pleaded guilty to war crimes for bombing civilian buildings. Each got 11 and a half years in prison. America's listening to Fox News.
It's the perfect season for a powerful business upgrade with Dell Technologies Summer Sale Event. Save up to 45% on secure PCs built for business with Windows 10 Pro. You'll also find great savings on Dell servers, monitors, docks, and other accessories to help boost productivity. Plus, enjoy free shipping on everything. Do more with modern devices and Windows 10 Pro. Call 877-ASK-DELL for a Dell Technologies advisor who can help you find the right tech. That's 877-ASK-DELL for business.
Sure, that's making headlines.
Summer Sale Event.
Did you know that most adults with autism are unemployed, and a major hurdle is the lack of job opportunities? That's why Autism Speaks is teaming up with Lee Container, the J. Donald and Laurel Lee Family Foundation Fund, and Delivering Jobs to create a more inclusive workforce in the U.S. Are you an HR professional, community leader, or business owner? Join us in creating a workforce where people of all abilities can contribute and thrive. To learn more, visit autismspeaks.org/employment.
Sky's the Limit Printing is your full-service screen print shop to get all your favorite t-shirts made. Why not place your logo and information about your company, and in a matter of moments, you become an instant walking billboard. Don't go a day without your company's information on your custom-made t-shirt or polo shirt. Sky's the Limit has the lowest prices and the best quality t-shirts to fit your budget. Call 772-340-1090. That's 772-340-1090. They can design a t-shirt that really will make your company shine. From long sleeves to short sleeves, tank tops, and many other types to choose from, Sky's the Limit can do it all. Call 772-340-1090. That's 772-340-1090. Don't forget, there's reunions and graduations coming up, so make sure to get your t-shirt order in as soon as possible. Call Sky's the Limit today, 772-340-1090.
Is the word at Port St. Lucie High School. Hi, this is Patrick Madden, drama director at Port St. Lucie High School, inviting you to our 25th anniversary summer production of Grease. This all-new production features a cast of over 40 with a live orchestra and is on stage from June 15th through June 19th at the Port St. Lucie High School Auditorium for seven big performances. And matinee and evening performances are available. The show features the irresistible songs from the hit movie, including You're the One That I Want, Hopelessly Devoted to You, and Summer Nights. Tickets are $20 and are on sale now at Perkins in Port St. Lucie, Vivid Salon in St. Lucie West, Joy's Ice Cream in Fort Pierce, and Honey Baked Ham in Stewart. Don't miss the event of the summer, Grease. For more information, visit pslhsdrama.com or call 337-6768.
Sky's the Limit Printing is your full-service screen print shop to get all your favorite t-shirts made. Why not place your logo and information about your company, and in a matter of moments, you become an instant walking billboard. Don't go a day without your company's information on your custom-made t-shirt or polo shirt. Sky's the Limit has the lowest prices and the best quality t-shirts to fit your budget. Call 772-340-1090. That's 772-340-1090. Randy. They can design a t-shirt that really will make your company shine. From long sleeves to short sleeves, tank tops, and many other types to choose from, Sky's the Limit can do it all. Call 772-340-1090. That's 772-340-1090. Don't forget, there's reunions and graduations coming up, so make sure to get your t-shirt order in as soon as possible. Call Sky's the Limit today, 772-340-1090.
Ellie's Downtown Deli is looking for fresh new faces with great outgoing personality and willing to work as a big team. Ellie's Original Downtown Deli and Ellie's Dockside Deli are looking for you. Ellie's is a fast-paced, busy operation that is looking for counter help, to-go packaging, waitresses and waiters, kitchen prep and cooks. Reach out now and set up your appointment at 772-781-6605 or email chefmarkmuller@gmail.com.
Coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world, it's the award-winning, critically acclaimed Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
And the top of the Tuesday morning to everybody.
I got some hot gossip.
Oh, really? I always love hot gossip.
Enough with the jibber-jabber.
All right. Well, just give me the gossip.
Hey! What are you trying to do?
Well, you know, I'm trying to run a radio show, okay? It is 7:08 this morning, Mr. Clock. Would you please certify the time?
It's now 7:08 a.m.
7:08 a.m. on the Get Up and Go Show. Sure, you remember who that is, Frankie Valli and the Three Seasons, or should I say the Four Seasons? I wonder why they call them the Four Seasons. I have no idea. Anyway, top of the morning to you. It's 7:09 on the Get Up and Go Show, and it's time to do our birthdays. If you are celebrating a birthday today, we say happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you and yours. And if you have somebody celebrating a birthday and you want to wish them a happy birthday, well, you know what? It's real simple. Just call us, 220-9788, 220-WSTU. Real simple. Very simple. Let's see here. Normani Corday from Fifth Harmony is 26 years old today. Azalea Banks, 31. Philippa Sue is 32. Waka Flocka Flame, 36 years old today. Eric Christian Olson is 45. That's Marty Deeks on NCIS Los Angeles. Colin Farrell is 46, the Penguin in the Batman. Archie Panjabi is 50 years old today. That's the New Zealander who lost the Amazing Race. Let's see here, who else? Brooke Shields, 57 years old today. The Blue Lagoon, Redneck Rita Gosner on the Middle, and Miley's dead mom on Hannah Montana. But Brooke Shields is 57. Hard to believe. Daryl McDaniels is 58. That's DMC of Run DMC. Some of their hits, Walk This Way, It's Tricky, and It's Like That. Corey Hart, 60 years old today, did the song Sunglasses at Night. Leah Thompson, 61. That's Caroline in the City and Back to the Future. Chris Elliott, 62 years old today, star of the old Fox sitcom Get a Life. Susie Essman is 67 years old today. That's Jeff's hilariously feisty wife, Susie, on Curb Your Enthusiasm. Tom Berenger is 73. That's Platoon, Major League, Inception, Hatfields and McCoys, Training Day, The Gingerbread Man, born on the 4th in July, many, many, many shows and movies. Hall of Famer Joe Namath, the quarterback, 79 years old, otherwise known as Mr. Pantyhose, Mr. Pitch anything he can to make a dollar on television. Sharon Gless, 76 years old today. She was the Cagney and Cagney and Lacey. Peter Yarrow, 84 years old today. The Peter and Peter, Paul and Mary. Clint Eastwood, go ahead, make my day. Yes, Clint Eastwood, 92 years old today. 92. Unbelievable. People celebrating a birthday in the heavens. John Bonham from Led Zeppelin passed away in 1980. Johnny Paycheck, the country legend, who did the song Take This Job and Shove It. He passed away in 2003. Prince Rainier of Monaco passed away in 2005. He's the guy who made Grace Kelly the first American princess when they married in 1956. Dr. Norman Peale passed away in 93. That's the author of one of the best self-help books of all time, The Power of Positive Thinking. And, of course, the classic poet, Walt Whitman, passed away in 1892. Time to rewind the clock and go back in the day. 163 years ago in 1859, Big Ben, the world's most famous clock, was completed in London and went into operation above the British Parliament. 163 years ago in 1859. 46 years ago in 1976, The Who headlined a concert in England and became the Guinness Book of World Records loudest rock band ever. Their set measured 126 decibels, which is as loud as a gunshot. Wow. 45 years ago today in 1977, the BBC banned the Sex Pistols song, God Save the Queen. 32 years ago in 1990, Seinfeld debuted on NBC. It took a few seasons to take off, but it is now regarded as one of the greatest TV shows of all time. 27 years ago today in 1995, Senator Bob Dole accused Hollywood of promoting violence, rape, and casual sex in music and movies. He said, quote, the mainstreaming of deviancy must come to an end. 24 years ago in 1998, Jerry Halliwell, otherwise known as Ginger Spice, confirmed she was leaving the Spice Girls. 22 years ago in 2000, the first episode of Survivor aired on CBS. 17 years ago in 2005, Christian Slater was arrested for grabbing a woman's buttocks on the streets of Manhattan. Ooh, not a good thing. Not a good thing at all. Today is National Macaroon Day. It is a soft and a little chewy, more like a cake than a cookie. It's also National Autonomous Vehicle Day. Now, I'm sorry, but, you know, I see these autonomous vehicles driving around tradition. You could not pay me enough to get into one of those things without a driver. Oh, no. No, not at all. It's also National Save Your Hearing Day. National Save Your Hearing Day. And lastly, it's National Smile Day. Yes, National Smile Day. So make sure and smile at somebody today. Time now, 7:16. Let's get back with G and Bonnie.
Plant, lawn, and garden problem. She provides solutions as well. Linda Lou Southbury. 7:16, the morning show. G and Bonnie, we'll be right back.
Living in Florida is paradise, or at least it is until your AC breaks down. And if it does, remember the name, Seacoast Air Conditioning. We offer service in hours, not days. While some AC companies might take a message, be slow to respond, or not answer at all, we at Seacoast always answer the phone, show up on time, and fix the problem right the first time. That's the Seacoast way.
Comfort crisis, don't roast. Call Seacoast.
Bonnie, the box office, and you mentioned this yesterday, the box office over Memorial Day weekend was all about Tom Cruise and Top Gun Maverick.
Mm-hmm.
You're right. And, you know, it was also the biggest opening ever for a Tom Cruise movie. Tom's previous best was War of the Worlds. That had a three-day opening take of $64.9 million in 2005. Let's see, the previous Memorial Day weekend record holder was Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End with $153 million. But Tom and his Top Gun Maverick, gee, like you said, taking in $156 million over its first 4 days, surpassed that one now.
Whoa. I mean, I guess... Well, now, was the previous record holder Pirates of the Caribbean?
Yes, indeed it was. And that was kind of like the year, 2005, maybe 2007?
That was $153 million.
$153 million.
But Bonnie, I don't remember this Tom Cruise movie, War of the Worlds. Why don't I remember that? Do you remember that?
I remember it, yeah, I do. That one came out, too, in 2005. War of the Worlds.
And that was his previous best, War of the Worlds, which had a three-day opening of $64.9 million in 2005.
You think Tom would have had another best movie that is, like, a little bit more well-known, you know, like, even you would think Born on the 4th of July would have topped that one.
What one is that when he's in his draws?
That's Risky Business. You would think Risky Business.
That was like one of his first movies.
Yeah, like I think like his very first one where we saw Tom for the.
And he was acting like he was playing a guitar with a broom or something.
Playing the guitar with a broom. He's in the living room.
And it's tidy whities.
Tidy whities.
The ones that Evan wears.
Thank you, with the onesie.
But you know, I like Tom Cruise when he plays. The Mission Impossible movies. I love them.
Oh, yeah.
Watch all of those. Didn't you, like, binge-watch those movies?
I think
movies
I have seen
one?
Every one of them. I mean, they're just, and there's always a scene in those movies where he runs. I love to see him run. He runs his butt off. You ever seen him run?
Yeah, he can run. And he can climb up the side of a mountain, too, like Spider-Man or something. He should play Spider-Man, you know, if he does his own... He does his own stunts in the movies, from what I hear.
They just showed a clip of our boy who's on trial right now.
And, Johnny Depp.
Johnny Depp. And, I don't know what Amber was thinking about this whole trial, but it seems as though Johnny Depp's, his brand has just gotten bigger. This trial has not done anything to diminish his brand. I mean, this brand is going crazy now. They're ready to hire him for this. And that. Disney missed a boat because I think Disney fired him with his Pirates of the Caribbean thing because they were afraid that it might tarnish their image and all that. Look what y'all did. Y'all messed up because this is making him a bigger brand.
You're right. And, you know, people are upset over that. How can you fire the best pirate ever? You know, it's probably like the most well-known, the coolest
pirate
that you've ever seen, right?
I mean, he's cooler than Captain Jack. Well.
He's pretty cool. He's pretty darn cool. You're right, G. And how can you fire that?
Yeah.
But this is going to be, there still isn't an outcome of this trial yet, is there?
I think it's going to come to a head pretty soon, though.
Pretty soon.
I don't know that anybody's going to get anything out of this. As far as monetary value and all that, I don't know. But it certainly has increased his brand, and he's worth a lot more money now since this trial. Okay, every time he shows up for the trial, everybody's like, oh, Johnny. And she's been getting death threats. I feel sorry for her.
Talking about putting
her baby in a microwave or something. These people are crazy.
That's horrible. Good morning now. It is 7:20. Bonnie, with a look at your local news stories. A 10-year-old... Florida fifth-grade student has been arrested after making a school threat, a sheriff's official said. Investigators learned of the threats made by the boy on Saturday and arrested him, Lee County Sheriff Carmine Morsino said in a social media post. The students' behavior is sickening, especially after the recent tragedy in Uvalde, Texas, the sheriff said. Marcino said that making sure our children are safe is paramount. According to the sheriff, investigators learned of a threatening text message sent by the boy who attended Patriot Elementary School in Cape Coral, which is near Fort Myers on Florida's Gulf Coast. The strongest hurricane on record to make landfall in May in the eastern Pacific has swept ashore on a stretch of tourist beaches and fishing towns in southern Mexico. Torrential rains and howling winds from Hurricane Agatha whipped palm trees and drove tourists and residents into shelters. The U.S. National Hurricane Center says it made landfall as a strong Category 2 hurricane Monday afternoon about 5 miles west of Puerto Angel. Thousands of flights across the U.S. were canceled this holiday weekend, causing chaos and major headaches for air travelers. There were a few cancellations at Palm Beach International Airport, but at Fort Lauderdale and Miami, more than 100 flights were scrubbed, leaving many passengers stranded. For the most part, it was business as usual at PBIA on Monday for those who decided to travel for the holiday. You know, as millions of Americans begin planning trips to their favorite beaches this summer, many people might be surprised to learn that some of this country's most tranquil pieces of coastline aren't always open to the public. We learn more from Chris Conkey.
Even if you don't live near the coast, there's nothing quite like a walk along the beach sometimes. And while millions of us prepare to head to one of our favorite summer spots in the next few months, you might be surprised to learn who exactly owns the shoreline. There is something about the sea, a certain kind of tranquility. But in some places where the waves lap upon the shore, that sand beneath them ultimately belongs to someone.
We need to be vigilant about public access to public spaces.
That's Julian Sear. He grew up in one of this country's coastal communities and is now a politician who is part of an ongoing push to make sure beaches continue to be part of the public's realm.
Government needs to make sure that the public can access these special places.
To understand how it came to be that in some states, individual property owners can own the beach, you have to travel back in time to when some of this country's first settlers created the colonial ordinances of 1641 to 1647. Those laws allowed for the building of private wharves to bolster maritime trade. Fast forward some 400 years, and still today, that same colonial ordinance is often interpreted to mean any homeowner can own a parcel of any beach that is part of their private property.
It is incredibly jarring to be, you know, communing with nature, if you will, and then you come across a sign, or worse, you come across, you know, someone who's saying, you know, you can't be there.
Julian isn't pushing to take people's property away, but rather ensure that no matter who technically owns a section of beach, the public is still allowed to be there.
The public loses out on a common resource.
That's Andrew Carl. He's done extensive research on why not every beach in this country is considered public land.
In a time where increasingly those who are the most fortunate have access and advantage to everything, I think it's really incumbent on those of us in government to make sure that the public can access these very special natural environments.
An effort to make sure some of our nation's most tranquil spots are open to everyone. I'm Chris Conti.
Mountain Dew has a devoted group of fans, and if you're one of them, would you be willing to down their latest concoction, which is pickle-flavored Ugh. Mountain Dew?
Say what?
Yeah.
Disgusting.
That sounds like one of those Evan
Disgusting.
Friends,
pickled...
That he would try, like he eats those hot potato chips Phil does. And
oh, Phil, Evan, you got to get on this with Phil. You got to do that taste test.
Already done.
Oh, you are? Yeah, okay. Wow.
There aren't many details yet other than it's supposedly a sour sweet complement to Southern barbecue. Huh? Mm-hmm. It's one of several new flavors that are being tested at Mountain Dew's new outpost in Backwoods, Tennessee. I want to go there. It's not widely available yet, but it could be if it's popular in the testing phase. Other Mountain Dew flavors being tested right now include apple cinnamon. I could
that
go
might
for
work,
that.
Yeah.
And one that should be good for you, elderberry.
I don't know what that tastes like.
Evan takes that as a vitamin.
Every day I take it.
as a vitamin, though, have you actually taken the eaten the berry?
It's like kind of grape flavored.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, it's not too bad.
Okay. That sounds good. Huckleberry Mountain Dew and S'mores Mountain Dew, if you want to try. I'll try them all.
You know, now, I can't get pickle juice. I mean, I like Lay's dill pickle chips.
Yeah, I do, too.
They taste really good, but I just can't imagine a pickle juice in a soda.
No, I can't.
It's probably okay. I mean, if I like the chips, I might like the soda. I don't know.
Yeah, it might be quite like Mountain Dew, only pickled.
Yeah.
Pickled at 7:26, and we'll have weather and traffic together next.
Time for a look at sports once again this morning, and San Francisco Giants manager Gabe Kapler stood when the national anthem was played before his team's game against the Phillies yesterday. Kapler, who began his protest against the direction of the nation on Friday, stood by himself at the railing of the Giants dugout during the playing of Taps during the holiday ceremony, which was followed by a rendition of the Star Spangled Banner by a military bugle company. A few other San Francisco players stood on the chalk line past the third base bag during their stretching exercises. "Today, I'll be standing for the anthem," Kapler said. "While I believe strongly in the right to protest and the importance of doing so, I also believe strongly in honoring and mourning our country's servicemen and women who fought and died for that right. Those who serve in our military, and especially those who have paid the ultimate price for our rights and freedoms, deserve that acknowledgement and respect, and I am honored to stand on the line today to show mine." 7:28 is the time right now. We'll have a look at traffic and weather coming up in just a moment.
Roberts, and I've been reporting on the Treasure Coast for years, long enough to know that this place is special.
Same here, Megan. I'm WPTV's Derek Lowe, and I grew up on the Treasure Coast. So take it from me, a lot has changed around here.
We're bringing you what's happening and why it matters. I'm WPTV's John Shainman, and there are so many impactful stories here, it makes you feel good about where you live.
WPTV Treasure Coast News every Saturday at 7 p.m.
And on WPSL at WSTU Sunday morning at 11.
7:28 is the time right now on the Get Up and Go show as we peer out the door once again checking traffic. Florida Turnpike and I-95 all looking good from Fort Pierce all the way down to the Jupiter area. All your side streets are looking good. No delays so far this morning. If you have to be to work by 8 a.m., you should be able to get there on time. That's your latest look at traffic. 77 degrees right now under partly cloudy skies. This weather report brought to you by Sailfish Roofing, a community roofing company you can trust for repairs or replacing a roof. Give them a call, 772-263-ROOF. Here's Katya Hall from WPTV with the weather.
WPTV First Alert Forecast calls for temperatures this morning in the low 70s with some spotty showers moving in from off the Atlantic. This afternoon, highs in the mid to upper 80s with scattered showers and storms. Some of those inland storms could be on the strong to severe side. Overnight, temperatures down to the 70s under partly cloudy skies and a few spotty showers into the overnight hours. Tomorrow, highs in the mid to upper 80s, scattered rain near the coast the early afternoon, then rain moving west towards the lake by the late afternoon hours. Thursday and Friday, highs in the mid to upper 80s with those afternoon to evening showers and storms.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
No hype, just facts. I'm Casey, and I invite you to tune into the Casey Ingram Show at my new time, Wednesdays at 10 a.m. Hear from community leaders, learn about some of our great nonprofit organizations, get the latest updates from our elected officials, and meet the candidates. Even rock and roll legends have joined the show from time to time. I'm conservative but not divisive, bringing you the talk of the community. It is a fun and interesting hour beginning at 10 a.m. every Wednesday on WSTU AM 1450 and Facebook Live at the Casey Ingram Show.
Are you an entrepreneur or business owner along the Treasure Coast? Well, then you should be tuning in to Small Biz Florida from the Florida Small Business Development Center at Indian River State College. Hi, I'm Tom Kinder, your host for Small Biz Florida. Entrepreneurs and business owners will learn how the Florida SBDC and IRSC can help you start, grow and accelerate your business.
Monday mornings at 11 on WSTU 1450 and worldwide on WPSLTV.com.
The professionals at Mark Brechtel Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses, schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy from St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We needed more space, so we had to move, but only right across the parking lot next to Subway. We're celebrating our move and new store with a huge sale. 25% off all jewelry, 30% off all Citizen watches, and 75% off all Invicta watches, including special orders. Just mention you heard it right here on WPSL or WSTU, and get the coolest T-shirt or keychain free while supplies last. And it might be the best time to sell, since gold has reached an all-time high, and we're paying more than ever for your scrap gold jewelry and your fine jewelry, as well as all of your coins and bullion products. St. Lucie Jewelry is the largest buyer of jewelry and coins since 1994, with two locations, one in St. Lucie West and one on the corner of Walton Road and US 1. Google us, check out our reviews, and come see us last.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to WSTUmorningshow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
This is not headline news. Scientists say there's something called a dipole repeller pushing up against our galaxy. Or maybe that's the plot of the new Stranger Things. I get confused. A California city will run out of water by July 1st. The good news is no one will notice because they're using their garden hoses to siphon gas. Mountain Dew may be coming out with a pickle-flavored soda this summer, just so those pineapple pizza freaks have someone to look down on. The Rock's daughter, Simone, is going to be a pro wrestler. Her wrestling name? Pebbles. And Clint Eastwood turns 92 today. Now when he says his iconic line, "Do you feel lucky?" it's when he holds out his finger and asks them to pull it. This is not headline news.
From not headline news to the stupid stuff.
And now it's time for stupid news.
It's so stupid and awesome.
Where we ask the important questions.
Are some people too stupid to live?
Why are people so stupid?
Oh yeah, we got some good stuff for you this morning. Coming off of a holiday weekend. Boy, we have some really good stuff. A 31-year-old mom in the United Kingdom named Bobby Lee recently had to have surgery, emergency surgery, after she swallowed one of those 6-inch long Q-tip things. She decided to swab her throat instead of her nose, which the FDA and Mayo Clinic have cautioned people against. And when she gagged, it got stuck, and it went halfway down her throat, and the end was still poking up onto the roof of her mouth. But she couldn't pull it out, and ended up swallowing the whole thing. Then she immediately drove herself to the emergency room. Well, by the time she saw a doctor, the swab was in her stomach and getting close to her intestines. So if it went any further, it could have punctured the intestines. But they'd never seen a case like that before, so they weren't sure what to do. They eventually decided to put a tiny camera down her throat and ended up pulling the swab out. Luckily, she's okay and can laugh about it now. No word on if she tested positive for COVID or not. That was the original reason why she was using the swab. Yeah, she was supposed to swab her nose and decided to swab her throat instead. Anyway, I don't know. It says specifically on the box, you know, swab your nose. Go in a circle 6 times in each nostril. pay attention, read the directions next time, and you probably won't have that happen to you. Here's another story for you. There's been so much talk about pandemic romance. There are the couples that split up because they couldn't stand being around each other 24/7. The couples who grew stronger after quarantining together, and the couples who met and even got married over Zoom. And now, one of the first couples to marry remotely while in lockdown is actually divorcing virtually. So they married remotely, virtually, and now they're divorcing virtually. A 26-year-old British woman named Elise Reeves filed for the annulment from her American husband, 24-year-old Darren Martin, just 3 months after marrying him over Zoom. And they still have not met in person. They met online during the quarantine, and things were good up until recently. Elise claims that Darren was unfaithful, and now she can't trust him anymore. She says his ex has confirmed that she and Darren are back together, and that they're even sleeping together. So I guess it's not a Zoom thing. Elise says, quote, "It wasn't the fairy tale ending she had hoped for." I just cannot picture this. You meet somebody over Zoom, you get married, and then you get divorced over Zoom. Just, it doesn't make any sense. Let's go to Washington State, where a man was arrested after road raging on an ambulance Monday evening. The ambulance was headed back to the local fire station when a man in a truck completely flipped out. He was mad because he thought the ambulance pulled out in front of him and was going too slow. It did not have its sirens on or anything of that sort. They came up on an intersection, and the guy pulled up next to the ambulance, confronted the crew, and rammed his truck into the side of the ambulance. His truck got wedged and stuck in the process, and the police showed up and noticed that the guy had beer and marijuana in the truck and was allegedly enjoying both while he was driving. He was arrested for DUI and possession and was taken to jail, and nobody was hurt. Yes, nobody was hurt. A Florida man is facing charges of misusing 911 after he allegedly placed repeated calls asking law enforcement officers to arrest President Joe Biden. Yes, to arrest President Biden. Jacob Philbeck, 29, was arrested on May the 8th after making a series of calls to the Pinellas County 911 system requesting that Biden be arrested and former drug kingpin Joaquin El Chapo Guzman be freed. Now, police said Philbeck was initially told that the information he was providing was a non-emergency situation and was warned not to make similar 9/11 calls. Well, Philbeck apparently didn't get the message, excuse me, because he called police saying again that President Biden needed to be arrested and put in prison, and El Chapo needed to be freed. Following the three calls to 9/11, deputies decided to pay Philbeck a visit around 6 a.m., At the time they stopped by, Philbeck was on the phone with 911, but that call was cut short by his arrest. Philbeck was taken into the county jail and booked on a charge of misusing the 911 system. He was later released after posting a $150 bond. That's it. That's all the bond was $150 for abusing the 911 system. I got to say good morning to Marty Jacobson, by the way. He texted me this morning. So, Marty, good morning to you, and hopefully I'll see you out at Clover Park tonight for Silver Slugger Night, which I know that you're usually there, right by the front gate. By the way, if you want to meet Marty Jacobson in person, you know, he's the guy that heads up the Seniors versus Crime organization. Head on over to Clover Park this evening. He's at the front gate every single Tuesday night, meeting and greeting people and handing out literature and the pamphlets for Seniors versus Crime. Great organization. You definitely want to check it out. I might even actually have Marty come in and co-host with me one morning and hang out for like 3 hours. That could be an adventure in itself. 7:41 on the Get Up and Go Show. We'll take a short pause. When we come back, we'll join back in with G and Bonnie.
And Bonnie. Ellie's Downtown Deli is looking for fresh new faces with great outgoing personality and willing to work as a big team. Ellie's Original Downtown Deli and Ellie's Dockside Deli are looking for you. Ellie's is a fast-paced, busy operation that is looking for counter help, to-go packaging, waitresses and waiters, kitchen prep and cooks. Reach out now and set up your appointment at 772-781-6605 or email chefmarkmuller@gmail.com.
What is your quality of life? The Owen Insurance Group plans on improving it on our Quality of Life radio show Tuesday mornings at 10 on both WPSL and WSTU. Hi, I'm Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group, along with Tom Bouvier. We'll help you on the road of life and make it a better one. Don't forget the Quality of Life radio show, Tuesdays at 10 on WPSL and WSTU on TuneIn and Alexa.
Sailfish Roofing is a locally owned company that, above all, offers honesty and integrity in everything they do. You can trust Sailfish Roofing to use quality materials and workmanship designed to give you peace of mind. Whether you're doing a re-roof, repair, or replacing an existing roof, Sailfish Roofing is a community roofing company you can trust. Call 772-263-ROOF.
In retirement, it's all about income, not spending down your principal. And anyone who tells you otherwise simply does not understand proper retirement planning. Hi, I'm Michael Burley of P Capital Management, inviting you to tune in to the Retirement Income Program. Powerful truths that you must know and understand so you may live the retirement you deserve. The key to retirement success is income. Tune in to the Retirement Income Program right here every Monday morning at 11.
The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
What are you waiting for? Call the Slim Body Laser Spa in Stewart today and start losing inches today. That's right, lose belly fat, your double chin, flabby thighs, upper arm fat. Well, you get the picture. In a short series of laser-assisted weight loss treatments, you can lose inches of unwanted fat. Call 223-5885.
The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
Weight, feel great and look fantastic with a little help from Dr. Fred J. Rezacker of Slim Body Laser Spa, East Ocean Boulevard in Stewart. And they're online. Visit their website, slimbodylaser.com. In a few short treatments, you'll see results. Lose 3, 6, even 9 inches of unwanted belly fat. The wait is over. Call today, 223-5885. That's 223-5885.
The Slim Body Laser Spa, the wait is over.
For more than 30 years, European Kitchen and Bath has been providing the highest quality kitchen and bath products to their customers on the Treasure Coast. Designer fixtures and quality products at affordable prices. So whatever you need, a new sink and faucet to upgrade your current kitchen or bath, or if you're planning a full 100% makeover, European Kitchen and Bath will help you from start to finish. European Kitchen and Bath, serving the entire Treasure Coast. Visit their website, EuropeanSync.com.
In Ag News from the Southeast AgNet, a diverse group of more than 40 American food and agriculture leaders sent a letter to U.S. Trade Representative Catherine Tai on tariffs. The groups are asking for the suspension, reduction, or elimination of tariffs to ease the burden of retaliatory tariffs on rural America. The letter was led by Farmers for Free Trade and came as the administration is working on a mandatory review of recently increased tariffs. Tariff changes are under review as part of the White House's efforts to address inflation. The letter says, quote, tariff relief could not come at a more important time. It goes on to say rural America and small businesses are facing significant challenges due to the lingering impacts of COVID-19, logistical and supply chain disruptions, record inflation, and the increasing impact of the war in Ukraine. The groups say removing tariffs on food and agricultural inputs and subsequent removal of burdensome retaliatory tariffs would provide immediate relief to U.S. food producers.
Farmers, produce safety inspections are here. Prepare your farm with an on-farm readiness review. The Florida Department of Agriculture and Consumer Services and University of Florida are partnering to provide this on-site preparation service for free. Our team of produce safety experts offer individualized support to make sure your operation meets the regulatory requirements. Contact us to help prepare your farm today. Request your free visit at www.fdacs.gov/OFRR. That's www.fdacs.gov/OFRR. Farmers, produce safety inspections are here. The Florida Department of Agriculture and Consumer Services and University of Florida are partnering to provide the produce safety trainings required for farms that grow, harvest, pack, or hold fresh fruits and vegetables. Seeding is limited. Make sure you meet the requirements of the produce safety rule and sign up today. Our next training will be held remotely via Zoom June 21st through the 23rd. For more information, visit www.fdacs.gov/FSMA.
I'm Sabrina Halverson for the Southeast AgNet.
If you have a suggestion for the show, we would love to hear from you. Send us an email to WSTUMorningShow@gmail.com. Now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
Buying a home is one of the biggest decisions in life. And here at Breaking and Entering Realtors, we keep all of your options open. Let's check out your neighbor's house.
Hey, what are you doing in my house?
Sir, sit down. I have a taser and I know how to use it. Take a look around, folks. See if it fits your lifestyle.
This is nice. It's not even for sale.
Well, it is now because I have buyers. We want it $20,000 under asking price and we want you out tomorrow.
I was just taking a nap.
Breaking and Entering Realtors. It's a buyer's market. Sometimes you just have to convince people it's time to sell. Sir, you need to get that door fixed.
7:48 is the time right now. Let's join back in with G and Bonnie.
Martin Roofing, we build trust with quality work. I'm Derek Alcius, owner of Martin County Roofing with more than 20 years experience in the roofing and construction industry. Whether you need a repair, restoration, or a new roof, both residential or commercial, we offer a seamless client experience, and we serve the entire Treasure Coast. Fully licensed and insured, we specialize in tile, metal, shingle, or flat roof. Contact us today for a free estimate at martincountyroofing.com.
Florida real estate is hotter than the weather. Now is a great time to find that dream home. I'm Eileen Simons, Realtor with eXp Realty. Join me for My Dream Home every Monday morning at 10 on WPSL and WSTU. We'll talk about real estate, answer your questions, interview guest experts, have featured listings, and a featured community each week. That's My Dream Home Radio Show, Mondays at 10 on WPSL and WSTU, or listen on Alexa, Google Home, or on the TuneIn app.
Join Joanne Seeger as she guides the Treasure Coast to health, one person at a time, on Joanne's World of Nutrition, now on a new day, Wednesday mornings at 10 on WPSL.
I am so excited to share with all my listeners all the cutting-edge health topics of today. I look forward to hearing from you. Remember, it's a live call-in show. Any questions you have on health and nutrition, I look forward to answering.
Join us here for Joanne's World of Nutrition every Wednesday morning at 10 on WPSL.
At St. Lucie Battery and Tire, batteries came before tires. We've been selling and servicing all types of batteries for over 50 years. So when you need a battery for nearly anything, we have it, as well as the fast, professional installation you need. We carry premium batteries for all your needs, automotive, commercial, marine, RV, and specialty. We also offer delivery and on-site installation. Serving our customers quality products for over 50 years in the home of honest, reliable service. Go to slbt.com and book your next appointment.
Attention growers, you have an important decision to make. The Citrus Research and Development Foundation wants a 3 cent per box levy on your fruit to fund their activities. Are your groves better off now than they were 10 years ago? Has CRDF done anything to help your groves after spending over $180 million to save your groves from citrus greening? Don't throw your good money at an organization that does nothing for you. Just say no when the CRDF asks you for the 3 cent per box levy. Paid for by the folks at SaveCitrus.com.
What's that smile about?
What are you smiling at?
The day happens to be National Smile Day.
Smiling's my favorite. And when you smile, it can make you or someone else feel better. Today is Smile Day.
There's that beautiful smile.
Is there anything that'll brighten your day more than someone flashing a big smile?
Grinning from ear to ear.
National Smile Day.
Hey, let's turn that phone upside down.
Say cheese.
Cheese.
It's showtime.
You know, is that you always hear that statement, that expression, it takes more muscles to frown than it does smile.
Mm-hmm.
But does anybody care? Do you care that it takes more muscles to frown?
No.
I don't care.
I never really think about it. You know what I find odd, though, Mr. G, lately?
What?
I find it, like, strange that I find it surprising lately when somebody smiles at me.
Oh, yeah?
Because...
Well, why?
Why?
The world is getting meaner.
There are nice people out there.
But you still have a face that makes a person smile. So it don't matter that it's getting meaner out there. Your face hasn't gotten meaner.
I hope not.
Now, they might not smile at you with those two double glasses that you have on there.
Oh, my gosh. Is she still wearing those?
Oh, she's got the double. She's got her reader. No, what are the first ones, Ron?
The first ones are my prescription glasses.
Okay, that's your distance glasses.
Yep.
And then she puts her readers on top of those.
And they look alike, but it looks like I'm double goggled.
Yeah, you are.
Like a flea stack or something, right?
You're double goggled right now, Bonnie.
Put a hood on me, and I'll look like one of those flea stacks from Land of the Lost.
Hmm. But what do you have on this whole smile thing?
Well, wear your best smile to this party as we're having a party as we celebrate National Smile Day every year on May 31st. Founded by, okay. So what profession do you think founded National Smile Day?
Dental.
Right on.
Yeah, makes sense.
That would make sense.
So because they can make money on it.
Yeah. Yep.
It's all about money, baby.
Founded by dentist Dr. Tim Steinman and Jim Wajella of Compassionate Dental Care in Lake in the Hills, Illinois.
Mm.
This day is meant to, you guessed it, share with the world what the power of a healthy smile can do.
Oh, and speaking of that, next Monday? Yeah, next Monday. I don't know. I guess I'll be here Tuesday. Next Monday, I'm getting the gum work done, Evan. Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
I'm having the surgery on the gums.
Are you now?
And this is when next Tuesday?
This is Monday.
Next Monday.
This is coming up Monday, yeah.
After you get off the air.
Yeah. No, I'm going to do it while I'm on the air.
Oh, that'd be even better.
Yeah, we're going to do a remote.
I love it. I love it. So that means Bonnie is going to be here.
No, we'll be fine.
You'll be getting your dental work for free.
Yeah, I got that right.
A little trade.
Oh, I never thought of that.
Uh-huh.
Let me make a call. We'll get back right back with you.
All right, thank you.
It's 7:54 right now. Good morning. I'm Bonnie with your news stories. You know, county fire crews worked overnight on Sunday to battle an approximately 40-acre brush fire near the 4700th block of Indrio Road, according to Daniel Mickles, a battalion chief of the St. Lucie County Fire District. At least 4 brush fire trucks responded to that area Sunday afternoon and worked until early Monday extinguishing the blaze. It was just one of 15 brush fires in St. Lucie County over a 2-day span, as hot and dry conditions increased the threat of fires, according to Brenda Stokes, spokesperson for the St. Lucie County Fire District. The fire was fully contained as of Monday afternoon, but the Okeechobee District of the Florida Forest Service was still working to put out several remaining hot spots or sporadic areas across the land that were slowly burning, according to Mickles. We thank T.C. Palm for that story this morning. The FDA and the CDC are investigating a hepatitis A outbreak possibly linked to organic strawberries. According to the agencies, the outbreak could be connected to 2 brands of the fruit that were sold at several retailers in the U.S. and Canada. They say Fresh Campo and Heb-branded strawberries purchased between March 5 and April 25th should not be consumed, The strawberries were past their shelf life, sold at retailers nationwide, including Walmart, Aldi, Kroger, Safeway, Trader Joe's, Sprouts Farmers Market, Heb, Wise Markets, and Winco Foods. There have been 15 cases reported in California and one case each in Minnesota and North Dakota. At least 17 illnesses and 12 hospitalizations have been recorded so far. And Paul Pelosi, the 82-year-old husband of U.S. Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi, was arrested this weekend on suspicion of DUI in Northern California. A police record showed on Sunday. Paul Pelosi was taken into custody late Saturday in Napa County, north of San Francisco. According to a sheriff's office online booking report, he could face charges including driving under the influence and driving with a blood alcohol content level of 0.08 or higher, the report said. Pelosi's bail was set for $5,000 for the two misdemeanors, record showed. 756 on our highways. Things are looking fine. No accidents to report. When you see one, report one to us. We're right here at 340-1590.
Oroso Cleaners has been there for you here on the Treasure Coast for more than three decades. Oroso Cleaners Valet Service, 985-2143. It's been serving all of St. Lucie County, North Stewart, and Palm City with no delivery fee. Oroso Cleaners with three locations to serve you. Or call the Valet Service, 985-2143. That's 985-2143. Oroso Cleaners.
Hi, this is Hawk Levy from St. Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We needed more space, so we had to move, but only right across the parking lot next to Subway. We're celebrating our move and new store with a huge sale. 25% off all jewelry, 30% off all Citizen watches, and 75% off all Invicta watches, including special orders. Just mention you heard it right here on WPSL or WSTU, and get the coolest T-shirt or keychain free while supplies last. And it might be the best time to sell, since gold has reached an all-time high, and we're paying more than ever for your scrap gold jewelry and your fine jewelry, as well as all of your coins and bullion products. St. Lucie Jewelry is the largest buyer of jewelry and coins since 1994, with two locations, one in St. Lucie West and one on the corner of Walton Road and US 1. Google us, check out our reviews, and come see us last.
Do you have issues on the job with wages or overtime, family and medical leave, disability issues, discrimination, or sexual harassment? Do you have a landlord and tenant problem or have a contract dispute? Have you been defamed or have your civil rights been violated? Hello, I'm attorney Stuart M. Address, and for more than 30 years, I've been fighting for the rights of everyday people. I believe in aggressive advocacy combined with personalized attention. That means being available to my clients. It means answering emails, sometimes at 3 in the morning, and checking my messages over the weekend. It means caring about you. If you want to speak with a lawyer who will not be intimidated and will actually care about you, call my office, Stuart M. Address, PA, at 772-781-8003, or send us a message through our website at www.stuartaddresslaw.com. We will respond to your calls and messages because we care.
Coming up on 8 a.m. right here at the Get Up and Go Show, we're WSTU Stewart, Martin County's Heritage Station. The news is coming up next, and then hour number three for you and me, Chief Deputy John Budensiek from the Martin County Sheriff's Office is going to be here joining me this morning, and we have got a great topic. We'll be talking about the tragic school shooting in Texas and how law enforcement reviews school safety protocols frequently to prepare for such incidents. Don't go anywhere.
Texas.
I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News.
I just kept hearing boom, boom, boom. It just kept going off, and it felt like an eternity.
Nicole Ogburn was a teacher in a different classroom at the elementary school. A gunman attacked, telling NBC's Today Show.
I just remember praying, please, God, keep us safe.
It was two other teachers and 19 kids who were murdered.
Today, at least four funerals, visitations, and one burial are on the calendar. It is going to take a lot of healing. We have seen volunteers and faith organizations from all over the country. Grief counselors have descended.
Fox's Casey Stegall in Uvalde, where the mayor wants that school building torn down. President Biden's pushing for stricter gun laws, and Democrats are holding compromise talks with some Republicans. Today, the president's focus is on the economy. Fox's Jackie Heinrichs at the White House.
The president's Oval Office meeting with Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell comes amid historic inflation, which the Fed is trying to address by raising interest rates at the highest rate since the 80s. And President Biden wants everyone to know that he is not ignoring this. He wrote in a Wall Street Journal op-ed, quote, "The global economy faces serious challenges. Inflation is elevated, exacerbated by Vladimir Putin's war in Ukraine. Energy markets are in turmoil. Supply chains that haven't fully healed are causing shortages and price hikes."
Now, gas is up another fraction to another record. AAA's national average for regular just over $4.62 per gallon. And oil's up $3 over $118 a barrel. That's flooding in Mexico after Hurricane Agatha. The first one in the Pacific this year was the strongest one to hit there in May ever as a Category 2. It was also stormy in Minnesota. A suspected tornado hit the town of Foreta hard.
The whole landscape's changed, and there's going to be a lot of construction.
Mayor David Reller, as many 100 homes were damaged. America's listening to Fox News.
It's the perfect season for a powerful business upgrade with Dell Technologies Summer Sale Event. Save up to 45% on secure PCs built for business with Windows 10 Pro. You'll also find great savings on Dell servers, monitors, docks, and other accessories to help boost productivity. Plus, enjoy free shipping on everything. Do more with modern devices and Windows 10 Pro. Call 877-ASK-DELL for a Dell Technologies advisor who can help you find the right tech. That's 877-ASK-DELL for business specials during Dell's Summer Sale Event.
Did you know that most adults with autism are unemployed, and a major hurdle is the lack of job opportunities? That's why Autism Speaks is teaming up with Lee Container, the J. Donald and Laurel Lee Family Foundation Fund, and Delivering Jobs to create a more inclusive workforce in the U.S. Are you an HR professional, community leader, or business owner? Join us in creating a workforce where people of all abilities can contribute and thrive. To learn more, visit autismspeaks.org/employment.
Well, days after the Uvalde, Texas massacre, there have been two people arrested in Florida for making threats on schools. One was just 10 years old in Lee County. In the other case,
Hillsborough County deputies arrested 18-year-old Corey Anderson and charged him with making a written or electronic threat to conduct a mass shooting. He was later released on bond. The post Anderson sent out showed him with guns and a protective vest, seeking directions to a school. The guns were determined to be airsoft guns, toys commonly used in training or recreational activities. Sheriff Chad Cronister called the post a sick joke. Gernal Scott, Fox News.
Well, someone else close to former President Trump is facing questions about what happened last year when rioters stormed the Capitol.
Peter Navarro, who was an advisor to former President Donald Trump, says he has been summoned to testify on Thursday to a federal grand jury and has been asked to give prosecutors any records he has that are related to the attack on the Capitol last year. The New York Times reports that the request includes any communications he had with the former president. The subpoena is separate from one he was sent in February by the House committee investigating the Capitol attack, which he has refused to cooperate with. The grand jury subpoena is the first issued in connection to the Justice Department's investigation to someone who worked inside the Trump White House. Tanya J. Powers, Fox News.
On Wall Street, stocks could drop. Dow futures down more than 200 points after a long holiday weekend. Now, last week, the Dow...
Life has taught you many lessons, like all you can eat is strangely unsatisfying. That's why it's better to have what you actually need. You've also learned that one size fits all never seems to fit. That's why a Cigna Medicare Advantage plan gives you care that fits your specific health needs. Learn more at CignaMedicare.com, because life has taught you well. Cigna is contracted with Medicare for PDP plans, HMO and PPO plans in select states, and with select state Medicaid programs. Enrollment in Cigna depends on contract renewal.
Taking your business to the next level requires money, and the Florida SBDC at Indian River State College has the expertise and connections to help you acquire your growth capital. Hi, I'm Michael Bernard, business consultant with the Florida SBDC at IRSC. We offer no-cost consulting and low-cost training to help you prepare and obtain financing. Whether you're looking for a traditional bank loan, government-backed loan, or a loan provided by an alternative lender, we have the tools, expertise, and resources to help you obtain the financing needed to succeed. While Florida SBDCs do not loan money or administer grants, our consultants maintain valuable relationships with local lenders and understand their lending requirements. Our certified business consultants, many of whom are former bankers and business owners, will provide confidential assistance to help guide you through the process of securing the right source of capital for your business.
For one-on-one business consulting at no cost, contact the Florida SBDC at IRSC at 336-6285, online at irscbiz.com.
Have you ever wanted to give someone your name and how to contact you, or maybe even your social media handle? How about you want to enter one of those contests where you drop your card in a fishbowl? Introducing the all-new personal business card. Everyone should have one. It's information presented in a professional manner, all about you and not scribbled on a piece of paper. Contact Sky's the Limit Printing in Port St. Lucie at 772-340-1090 and ask them about their all-new personal business card. It's great for people of all ages, so you don't have to scramble for a piece of paper or a pen. Plus, if you have a social media name that's a little long to rattle off, print it all on the personal business card. Yes, the old-time calling card is back with new features. Contact Sky's the Limit Printing at 772-340-1090, 772-340-1090. See why people on the Treasure Coast turn to Sky's the Limit. Give them a call, 772-340-1090. You'll be glad you did. Ellie's Downtown Deli has a brand new location that is now serving breakfast and lunch. It's Ellie's Dockside Deli, located at 3555 Southeast St. Lucie Boulevard in the Waterside Sailfish Marina. Ellie's Dockside Deli will be serving breakfast and lunch from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. Wednesday through Sunday. Enjoy many items from their breakfast and lunch menu before you head out on your boat for the day, or why not enjoy breakfast or lunch right outside at one of the tables by the water. With Ellie's Dockside Deli, they'll even cater your next event for you and your friends.
This is Chef Mark Muller inviting you to enjoy breakfast and lunch at our newest location, Ellie's Dockside Deli. Plus, find out why our business catering means business for your business.
Ellie's Dockside Deli, located at 3555 Southeast St. Lucie Boulevard in the Waterside Sailfish Marina. They are open from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. Wednesday through Sunday. Call 772-291-2706. That's Ellie's Dockside Deli in the Waterside Sailfish Marina.
Coming to you live from Stuart, Florida, the greatest little town in the world. It's the award-winning, critically acclaimed Get Up and Go Show on AM 1450 WSTU. You're invited to call the show anytime at 772-220-9788. And now, broadcasting live from their palatial studios, here are your hosts, Evan and Bonnie.
Thank you very much, Mr. Announcer.
They're going to hate you so much.
Why are they going to hate me? My gosh, I haven't done nothing wrong.
Oh, wow. What's today?
Today is Tuesday. Today is Tuesday.
Well, get to it.
All right, I'll get to it. First, I have to tell you the time. It's 8:09. Mr. Clock, would you please do the honors?
It's now 8:09 a.m.
8:09 a.m. Indeed it is on the Get Up and Go Show. I love the slamming of that jail door. And as always, it's time for our weekly visit with the Martin County Sheriff's Office. Chief Deputy John Budensiek joins us on our line right now. John, good morning to you.
Good morning. How are you this morning?
I am fantastic. How was the holiday weekend for you and the family, and then, of course, you and all the deputies that are out there serving?
It was a nice, warm weekend for the family and I, and then the deputies were busy. The sandbars were hopping, even with the cloudiness and a little bit of rain. We got sandbars, beaches, and then the calls for service were pretty significant, but nothing that was earth-shattering.
That's a good thing. Thank the Lord for that, right?
Absolutely.
I saw that yourself and the sheriff partook in a nice little tribute for the soldiers that gave their lives on Memorial Day yesterday. That was very nice of what was going on.
We did. There's a small parade every year, which is it's actually a quaint, nice, well done parade, Memorial Day parade, and then there's a follow up service right after that in Memorial Park there in the city of Stewart. So
mm-hmm.
we did participate along with our representative Snyder, and it was fairly well attended. It was a good crowd yesterday.
Very good, very good, very good. I wanted to have a conversation with you this morning. You're a dad. I'm a dad. The tragic shooting in Texas. I still can't wrap my head around the whole situation, all the things that have gone on, all the truths that are now coming out. There's just so many different things that have the stories have changed, my gosh, so many times. But I want to have a conversation with you about how the local law enforcement goes over all the school safety protocols very frequently to prepare, God forbid, an incident like this should happen in one of our schools.
Absolutely, and you're right, Evan. We're in that what we call the fog of war stage, where the facts or the story, they're not really facts, but we believe them to be facts, are changing almost every day as they peel back the layers of the onion of exactly what happened out there.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, in the state of Florida, because of the shooting down in Parkland, we learned the hard way that our old police tactics were not working. And that means in that shooting, specifically in Parkland, law enforcement was always taught, wait for backup, wait till you have a tactical team or a more efficient team or better weapons before you proceed into gunfire or something that could be perceived to be violent. And
right.
Those tactics, excluding active shooters, are still in place right now. If we had a stolen car moving through Martin County and a unit got behind it, that unit would wait on another one or two units as backup before they try to do a traffic stop. Or if we had a burglary in progress at a house, that unit would wait on a canine or a helicopter or other units. So that has been how law enforcement was trained up until Parkland and then the sweeping legislation with Stoneman Douglas. We learned how many lives potentially could have been saved and that shooter could have been stopped had those officers gone straight in. Now, for personal protection, it's counterintuitive, but our deputies, along with every deputy in the state of Florida, are trained if there is an active shooter. That's one instance where you go in regardless of how well equipped you are firearm wise. You know, we know that in both Parkland and in the shooting out in Uvalde, the shooter had a .223 rifle, which we have, but our school resource officers don't walk around all day long in the schools with .223 rifles. They walk around handguns. So
right.
Mismatch there, just showing up for work, and they know that. But regardless of the mismatch and regardless of the lack of backup, our officers across the state are trained to go straight into harm's way, and sometimes it could be or is likely to be at their own peril. But that is just the new way of doing business. We no longer wait on backup. We no longer wait on two and three units. We go straight in. Another thing we have going for us, unfortunately, in Florida, because we learned the hard way, is you know, we have dedicated school resource officers in every public school, including elementary schools. And prior to Stoneman Douglas, we did not have that. We only had school resource officers in high schools. So we in Florida, again, have learned the hard way. And my suspicion is in Uvalde, Texas, they're tracking where we were, what, 5 or 6 years ago here.
Right. They're behind.
They're behind. And I know that's a, of course, I've Googled it and read about it. And I know it's a small town, 50 to 75 miles north of the border, and my guess is they didn't have a real SWAT team, and they weren't prepared. And I know their chief has gone on there saying they did active shooter training, but I don't know what that consists of.
Yeah.
And we'll figure that out as time goes on. And I don't want to be critical.
Right.
I wasn't there. Clearly there was 19 officers who held up outside of that door that thought that was a good idea not to go in.
Yeah.
And I know the rationale that it transitioned from an active shooter to a barricaded gunman, but then, you know, I guess we asked the question, well, what about the people who were already shot that maybe we could have got in and saved their lives?
Every second, I mean, literally every second mattered in that situation. And had they gone in and breached the door, which is the hot topic right now, they gone in and breached the door like they should have, then there's a possibility there wouldn't have been so much loss of life.
You're right. And we look at that. You know, we've been covering it in our briefings. Again, we do active shooter training here annually, and then we go over it, and we go over it again verbally. I went over it again the other night in briefing. Like, look, it may feel like suicide mission is the wrong word, but those are words that I use.
Yeah.
But they may feel like that. Like, you're going in there, your odds are slim to none, but that's the risk that we take in law enforcement.
Right.
But in our agency, we set aside a training week out of the year for everyone, and our training unit is, I believe, cutting edge with their active shooter training. You know, it's force on force, so they take we call them Sims guns. They hurt. It's kind of like playing a high power game of paintball, but, you know, it hurts when you mess up or you don't use the right tactic. But our officers go through. We actually train in some schools. We train in different businesses, and we just try to pound that thought in their head that, you know, this could be you.
You know, something that I just don't simply understand, when they held a press conference on TV the other day and the chief of police was nowhere to be found, literally nowhere to be found, and they had another gentleman fielding the questions from the media, and then another gentleman was picking the different media people to ask the questions. I couldn't wrap my whole head around that whole thing.
Well, as you know, police chiefs are in a different scenario than a sheriff would be. So if something happened here and we as a sheriff's office had messed up or done something wrong, the sheriff would make a point to be the guy answering the questions, whether they're positive or negative.
Right.
But a police chief answers to the city or town council, and they can tell him not to be up in front. They can dictate what he does or does not do. So
right.
I don't know why he wasn't there. He might not have been allowed to be there. He might have been ordered not to be there.
Mm-hmm.
But I have noticed that where Texas DPS seems to have taken over the investigation, and they're answering most of the questions now.
So. And the other question that has come up also was, where was the school resource officer? He wasn't there.
I'm not sure that there was one. Of course, the initial reports, you heard the same thing I heard, was that a school resource officer engaged him outside of the building and there was a firefight. Well, that, as they unraveled that did not take place. And back to what I was saying, Texas hasn't gone through a Parkland like we went through.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a grade school. This is a middle grade school. So they may not have had one there, and that's something that I'm sure we'll find out eventually. But you know what? 10 years ago, Martin County didn't have school resource officers in grade schools either.
Yeah.
We only put them there post-Parkland.
Yeah.
So they're probably clearly behind the times. And I'll tell you this, Evan, it's an everyday effort, and our sheriff's office works extremely well with the Martin County School Board.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Teachers, their employees, because if you followed our Facebook last week, we get threats. The school gets threats you know, their veiled threats, their overt threats.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes on a weekly basis, and our detectives, our officers work with the school all the time on educating the parents of what's going on, educating the parents of whether the threats are real or not, dealing with these youth trying to figure out, were they serious? Do they have the ability to do it? Like, it's a nonstop function for us, just dealing with kids most of the time doing stupid things or posting something that they think is funny on Instagram, and then we have to go deal with it.
Yeah. You know, I wish I had more time to chat with you on this topic, because I could literally talk to you for a whole hour about this, the importance of safety, et cetera, so on and so forth. But unfortunately, time has expired, and I wish it didn't, and I want to continue the conversation as well, maybe next week, and pick up where we left off and talk some more about this.
Sure.
But our special guest this morning has been Chief Deputy John Budensiek from the Martin County Sheriff's Office. He always keeps us abreast of everything that's happening in Martin County with law enforcement and catches us up to date on everything that's going on. John, it's always a pleasure to have you on the program. I really appreciate you.
The pleasure was mine, and we'll talk next week.
We definitely will. Take care now. It's time for the Precious Metals Report, brought to you by St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin. Gold opening up at $1,851.60 an ounce. Silver opening up at $21.65 an ounce. That's the Precious Metals Report. It's all brought to you by St. Lucie Jewelry and Coin.
Hi, this is Hawk Lee
from St.
Lucie Jewelry and Coins. We needed more space, so we had to move, but only right across the parking lot next to Subway. We're celebrating our move and new store with a huge sale. 25% off all jewelry, 30% off all Citizen watches, and 75% off all Invicta watches, including special orders. Just mention you heard it right here on WPSL or WSTU, and get the coolest T-shirt or keychain free while supplies last. And it might be the best time to sell, since gold has reached an all-time high, and we're paying more than ever for your scrap gold jewelry and your fine jewelry, as well as all of your coins and bullion products. St. Lucie Jewelry is the largest buyer of jewelry and coins since 1994, with two locations, one in St. Lucie West and one on the corner of Walton Road and US 1. Google us, check out our
reviews, kind of
and come see us last.
Time now is coming up on 8:24 on the Get Up and Go Show. We're going to join back in with G and Bonnie at this time.
Yeah,
that struck me as a little racy, just when you played that right there.
That's how it was back in the 80s.
I didn't remember how young she looked.
She was definitely a teenager.
Yeah. Colin Farrell is 46. The Penguin in Batman. Yeah, you do that good. And he was in Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them.
I never saw that. I wanted to see that movie, and I never got a chance to see it.
Are those good movies?
The trailer made me itch, though. I got to tell you that.
Why did it now?
Because it had some really freaky creatures in it.
No kidding.
Oh, heck yeah.
You know, I bet this is one I would probably want to see on the big screen.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like, you know what? Which movie I wish they would bring to the big screen is Goosebumps. We watch that every single Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we watch 1, 2. I can't remember if there's a 3. I know there's a part 1 and part 2. But those are like the best Halloween movies you've ever seen. You know, where the creatures come to life and in the stores with all the Halloween decorations,
oh,
they come to life.
And, of course, the person that goes down in the cellar gets killed first. He wants to hear what that noise was down there and all that. Those Halloween movies do nothing for me.
Oh, really?
No.
Oh, yeah. That's Halloween is a classic.
Mm.
I can still watch.
With our girl?
Yeah, with
Jamie Curtis? Jamie Lee?
The Scream Queen.
Oh.
The caller.
Mm.
Uh-huh. I could get into that one every year. Happy birthday if you're celebrating today.
We were talking about movies. Top Gun Maverick broke the record. The best, Memorial Day weekend opening in the U.S., Bonnie. It took in $156 million over its first 4 days. And it's also the biggest opener ever for a Tom Cruise movie.
You know, if I come back in another life, I want my first name to be Tom.
Oh, you do?
Doesn't it seem like Tom never loses? You got Tom Cruise, you got Tom Brady. Like
Tom Thumb.
Tom and Jerry.
I'm trying to think of another. I'm trying to think of a loser, Tom. I can't think of one, though.
I don't think there is a loser, Tom.
Tom Club.
Major Tom? No. No, that's it. That's good. That's
Tommy
good.
John? Wasn't there a Tommy John?
And the Shondells? Oh, that was Tommy James.
Tommy James. Yeah. He wasn't a loser either, so. Good morning. I'm Bonnie with a look at your news stories, and we're going to start with a Jupiter Middle School student competing in Scripps National Spelling Bee. We hear more from WPTV's Stephanie Susskind.
The all-star speller from Jupiter Middle School will compete on the big stage at the Scripps National Spelling Bee.
National Spelling Bee Finals.
That's always been my dream.
She says she loves learning new words and their meaning. Her favorite word to spell?
Bouillabaisse, which is like a French, like, stew of seafood. It's Bouillabaisse.
A perfect score on a third grade spelling test sparked her spelling bee bug. She won a school bee this year and then the regional competition.
It's really exciting, but also nerve-wracking, and you learn how to be calm under pressure.
She's very detail-oriented, and she is dedicated, and she is a straight-A student across the board. And what I really like about Varshita is that she's very humble.
Christine McAlexander is Varshita's English teacher and helped her establish a spelling bee club at the school.
After I got to know her and I saw how passionate she was about the club and how dedicated she was to studying, I couldn't say no.
But now it's time for the big bee.
So all the spellers know is that all of the words come from the dictionary, but they're not studying in a book like this anymore. Now it's all online.
Christella West.
C-R-Y-S-T.
Varshita uses a website called Spell Pundit to study 3 to 4 hours a day and 5 to 6 on the weekends.
First, like, read over each word, and then I, like, test myself, and then I, like, retest myself on the ones that I got wrong. And then I also study root words, and I write, like, flashcards and sticky notes and hang them up on my wall.
She's ready to take on the best of the best.
Hoping for a word that I know.
And leave the competition buzzing behind her. Stephanie Susskind, WPTV, News Channel 5.
The strongest hurricane on record to make landfall in May in the eastern Pacific has swept ashore on a stretch of tourist beaches and fishing towns in southern Mexico. Torrential rains and howling winds from Hurricane Agatha whipped palm trees and drove tourists and residents into shelters. The U.S. National Hurricane Center says it made landfall as a strong Category 2 hurricane Monday afternoon about 5 miles west of Porto Angel. Our news time at 8:28. We'll have a look at traffic and weather together next.
Okay, bye.
8:28, quick look at the Major League Baseball scoreboard. The Brewers over the Cubs, Tigers over the Twins, the Cards over the Padres, the Giants beat Phillies, the Astros over the Athletics, Rockies over the Marlins, Guardians, I can't say that, Cleveland over the Royals, 7-3, the Orioles blank the Red Sox, 10-0, Mets over the Nationals, 13-5, Brewers over the Cubbies, Rangers over the Rays, Diamondbacks over the Braves, and the Dodgers fell to the Pirates. 8:29 is your time, and we'll have a look at traffic and weather coming up next.
Professionals at Mark Brechtel Certified Public Accountants are proud to sponsor Treasure Coast Solutions, a community service program designed to provide information you can use, a local perspective on national issues, local solutions to meet your individual concerns. At our firm, we believe that information is knowledge, and with knowledge comes the power to have a positive impact on our lives, businesses, schools, and community. If you would like one of our professionals to address your personal financial or business concerns, please give us a call to set up an appointment at 220-3380.
Eight:30 is the time right now on the Get Up and Go show. We have one accident to report right now, a vehicle crash. 95 southbound, mile marker 114. That's at Becker Road, 114. Unknown debris in the road. No injuries. Otherwise, everything else is looking clean. and green all the way. That's your latest look at traffic. 77 degrees under partly sunny skies here on the Treasure Coast. Time for a look at your weather from WPTV and Katia Hall, all brought to you by Sailfish Roofing, the community roofing company you can trust for all your repairs. Give them a call, 772-263-ROOF.
Your WPTV First Alert forecast calls for temperatures this morning in the low 70s with some spotty showers moving in from off the Atlantic. This afternoon, highs in the mid to upper 80s with scattered showers and storms. Some of those inland storms could be on the strong to severe side. Overnight, temperatures down to the 70s under partly cloudy skies and a few spotty showers into the overnight hours. Tomorrow, highs in the mid to upper 80s, scattered rain near the coast the early afternoon, then rain moving west towards the lake by the late afternoon hours. Thursday and Friday, highs in the mid to upper 80s with those afternoon to evening showers and storms.
I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Katya Hall on WSTU AM 1450, Martin County's Heritage Station.
No hype, just facts. I'm Casey, and I invite you to tune into the Casey Ingram Show at my new time, Wednesdays at 10 a.m. Hear from community leaders, learn about some of our great nonprofit organizations, get the latest updates from our elected officials, and meet the candidates. Even rock and roll legends have joined the show from time to time. I'm conservative, but not divisive, bringing you the talk of the community. It is a fun and interesting hour beginning at 10 a.m. every Wednesday on WSTU AM 1450 and Facebook Live at the Casey Ingram Show.
Lush Color and Extension Bar, new to downtown Stewart on Albany Avenue and Ocean Boulevard, offering all services including color, cuts, blowouts, keratin, and extensions. Our stylists have years of experience, are masters of their craft. Call us today for an appointment, 772-872-6087. 772-872-6087. Lush Color and Extension Bar. For more than 30 years, European Kitchen and Bath has been providing the highest quality kitchen and bath products to their customers on the Treasure Coast. Designer fixtures and quality products at affordable prices. So whatever you need, a new sink and faucet to upgrade your current kitchen or bath, or if you're planning a full 100% makeover, European Kitchen and Bath will help you from start to finish. European Kitchen and Bath, serving the entire Treasure Coast. Visit their website, EuropeanSync.com.
Reese is the word at Port St. Lucie High School. Hi, this is Patrick Madden, drama director at Port St. Lucie High School, inviting you to our 25th anniversary summer production of Grease. This all-new production features a cast of over 40 with a live orchestra and is on stage from June 15th through June 19th at the Port St. Lucie High School Auditorium for 7 big performances. And matinee and evening performances are available. The show features the irresistible songs from the hit movie, including You're the One That I Want, Hopelessly Devoted to You, and Summer Nights. Tickets are $20 and are on sale now at Perkins in Port St. Lucie, Vivid Salon in St. Lucie West, Joy's Ice Cream in Fort Pierce, and Honey Baked Ham in Stewart. Don't miss the event of the summer, Grease. For more information, visit pslhsdrama.com or call 337-6768.
But Get Up and Go Show would love to hear from you live on the air. Give us a call at any time. Now let's get back to the program. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
8:34 is the time right now on the Tuesday morning edition of the program. And without further ado, here's Randy Segal, Captain Randy Segal, with a space report. Good morning, Captain.
Good morning, Admiral. Well, it was on this date in history that Russia launched its Kristall module to their Mir space station. The Kristall module was an interesting module because it was designed to allow for the production of crystals in space. Semiconductors would be used also. And it also would bring new solar arrays and life support to the space station. The Kristall module was designed to allow large objects to dock to the space station, such as the Russian Buran space rocket. The Buran, similar to the space shuttle, was to dock with that vehicle. However, as we know, Buran never made an operational spaceflight due to costs and the change of Russian government. But this Kristal module allowed large docking ports as well as smaller docking ports on the vehicle. Today also marks the start of the European Space Agency. It was formed on this date in history in 1975. Well, Soichi Noguchi is no longer an astronaut. Soichi Noguchi has retired after 26 years working for the Japanese Space Agency. He said that he realized after his third flight that he experienced burnout, and as a result, he decided to quit and get back into the environment of working for government institutions. He said it became too easy, and he was burned out from all the work he's done in space. So we wish Soichi Noguchi good success in his future endeavors. The crew on board the International Space Station doesn't let moss grow under their feet. The crew scanned each other's eyes using ultrasound 2 device. Flight engineer Kajil Ingren, Bob Hines, Samantha Cristofiorte from the European Space Agency, and Jessica Watkins, they gathered in the Columbus module for eye scans. Real-time support came from professionals on the ground. The results will help doctors understand how living in weightlessness impacts the eye, the retina, and vision. The astronauts also continued to work on blood flow experiments on the station. They want to know how the blood flows between the head, the chest, and the rest of the body in order to see why astronauts experience lightheadedness and changes in their blood pressure when they return to Earth. So they do a lot of testing. The commander of the station, Oleg Artsenev, and flight engineer Denis Medvev spent time in the Zvezda module working on the treadmill vibration systems to make sure it's up and running in a proper fashion. Sergei Korsakov worked on 2 different Russian experiments, exploring cardiovascular systems adaptation to microgravity and other researching advanced Earth photography techniques. Well, we're getting ready for a new cargo ship to go to the International Space Station. The cargo ship will be launched on Friday, June the 3rd. It'll carry about 2.5 tons of cargo for the crew on board the station. The Progress MS-20 has been stacked on top of its carrier rocket, the Soyuz 21A, and they're ready to start going to the launch pad and then launching to the space station. NASA is anxious to get the wet dress rehearsal done on its Artemis 1 vehicle. But due to conflicts of timing, they will not be able to do this until June the 19th. They're concerned about a lot of the storms that have popped up around the Cape, and they're also concerned about getting the vehicle in the best shape it's in so that they can test it. The reason for all this testing is that they want to launch Artemis 1 on a mission around the moon as soon as possible. However, in the act of caution, they're not going to do so until they have fully tested the vehicle. So they can't have that wet dress rehearsal for a little while longer. Meanwhile, SpaceX is having trouble with their Starship prototype. They have not been able to get Starship fully loaded and ready to fly due to FAA regulations. Tomorrow we're going to tell you about Relativity Space, who will be doing a 3D printing, as well as India wanting to go into space. So until tomorrow, have a great day, everybody.
That's Randy Segal with the Space Report. He joins us on the program each and every week at this time. And normally at this time, when you hear this music, I'm talking about Ellie's Dockside Deli in their newest location. But I've got on the phone with me the gentleman that heads up that whole conglomeration of Ellie's Dockside Deli and Ellie's Downtown Deli. and I actually saw him this weekend at an event that we were both at doing. Chef Mark is on the phone with us this morning, and I can't believe it. Been on the radio for 2 years here, and this is the first time I've had him on the morning show. Chef Mark, top of the morning to you.
Good morning, sir. How are you today?
I am fantabulous, and, you know, I've always patronized your business down here, the deli. I've gone and had lunch there several times.
Yes, sir.
And the new breakfast place is doing fantastic where you guys are serving lunch. And we talk about your catering side of the business, and I've never actually had a chance to see you in action until this past Saturday night at a birthday party that I had my photo booth at, and you were there cooking up a storm, and I got to tell you, you were cooking up some good vittles.
It was a great evening. We love doing the pasta bar. Action bars are always fun. Get you involved.
It's really, really cool to see you do your thing, and this is just a small little sample of the different things that Chef Mark can do for you from Ellie's Downtown Deli and Ellie's Dockside Deli as well. Now, you had the pasta bar on site where you were making orders right there on the spot for exactly the way people wanted it, didn't you?
Correct. Just like your traditional omelet bar, but with pasta. More fun.
Yeah, it was really cool. You had spaghetti, and then you had, was it penne?
I had some rotini out to choose from as well.
Rotini, yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah, you had rotini and the noodles, spaghetti mm-hmm. noodles. And then you had all the different ingredients from hot. I think I heard you say something about a hot and spicy ham.
We did. We had hot ham, asparagus, peppers, onions, sausage, ground beef, chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Two different sauces. You do an Alfredo or marinara. You can mix the two to make a blush sauce. So we mix it up any way you like it.
I love it. Absolutely love it. Let me give out his phone number if you want to give Chef Mark a call at the location in downtown Stewart. It's 772-781-6605. And he will cater any event, and I mean any event from 10 to 1,000 people. He will come with his staff, and they will prepare a 5-star meal for you. But more importantly, Mark, let's talk a little bit more about the new location, Ellie's Dockside Deli, where you have full breakfast available Wednesday through Sunday from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. Tell us about the location and all the different things that you guys are doing down there.
So we're trying to cater like we cater to your office and lunch crowds here in downtown Stewart. We're trying to cater to all the marina folks, captains, charters, anybody involved with the marine industry.
Mm-hmm.
If you need to set up party platters for your boat to take out that day, any of the above. We'll do a cocktail party on your yacht if we need to. Just give us a call, and we'll straighten out whatever it is we need to take care of.
All right. Their new location is at 3585 Southeast St. Lucie Boulevard.
65.
Oh, okay. I'm reading off the website. The website says 3585.
Oh,
got to make a correction on that one. Okay, 3565 in downtown Stewart on St. Lucie Boulevard. Make sure and check that out. 3535. Why? Now, see, I've got all these different addresses for you. I've got 3555, 3585, 3565. You know what? All you got to do is head down to the Waterside Sailfish Marina. That's where they're located at. You're going to see the big sign out front. 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. is when they're open from Wednesday through Sunday. The number down there to call, 772-291-2706. They're on the Waterside Sailfish Marina. You guys have got a full breakfast menu also available for our listeners too, right?
You know, your basic deli affair, mm-hmm. bacon, egg, cheese, sausage, pork roll, mm-hmm. Burritos, French toast sticks, biscuits and gravy, you know, fresh fruit, yogurt, that kind of item. Stuff that's easy to go.
Really, really simple, easy to go. But the best part about it is, Chef Mark, it's all cooked fresh right on the spot. It's not
correct.
Sitting in that warmer for hours like other places. It's all freshly made, which is great.
Yes, right in front of you.
And you have the award-winning lunch menu available as well, just like you serve in downtown Stewart, right?
Correct. Same exact full menu.
All right. Make sure and get down there. They're in the Waterside Sailfish Marina Wednesday through Sunday, 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. Go down there and check out their brand-new location, Ellie's Dockside Deli. And, of course, you have Ellie's Downtown Deli right here in downtown Stewart as well. Mark, I'll let you get back to what you're doing. I know you got a busy day ahead of you. You guys
Thank you, sir, yesterday.
I appreciate
you having me.
And I appreciate you being on the radio and taking time out. Thanks so much, and we'll talk to you real soon.
You got it.
All right, have a great day. We'll take a short pause for the cause, and we'll be back right after this.
Are you an entrepreneur or a business owner along the Treasure Coast? Well, then you should be tuning in to Small Biz Florida from the Florida Small Business Development Center at Indian River State College. Hi, I'm Tom Kinder, your host for Small Biz Florida. Entrepreneurs and business owners will learn how the Florida SBDC and IRSC can help you start, grow, and accelerate your business. Monday mornings at 11 on WSTU 1450 and worldwide on WPSLTV.com. Sailfish Roofing is a locally owned company that, above all, offers honesty and integrity in everything they do. You can trust Sailfish Roofing to use quality materials and workmanship designed to give you peace of mind. Whether you're doing a re-roof, repair, or replacing an existing roof, Sailfish Roofing is a community roofing company you can trust. Call 772-263-ROOF.
Hi, this is Michael Burley of Peak Capital Management. Every month we're hosting live educational retirement planning events. Some are in-person workshops and some are online webinars. Whatever works best for you, you're invited. And here's what's coming up.
Consider this your personal invitation to join Michael Burley and the team of Peak Capital Management for a live seminar on Social Security coming up June 7th, 6 p.m. at IRSC in Stewart. Do you know the top claiming strategy for Social Security for your individual situation? If not, this workshop is for you. So join us June 7th, 6 p.m. at IRSC in Stewart.
We'd love to have you attend one of our next educational events, in person or online, whatever works best for you. Call 772-334-9592. That's 772-334-9592. Or visit peakcapitalmanagement.com. In retirement, it's all about income, not spending down your principal. And anyone who tells you otherwise simply does not understand proper retirement planning. I am Michael Burley of Peak Capital Management, inviting you to tune in to the Retirement Income Program. Powerful truths that you must know and understand so you may live the retirement you deserve. The key to retirement success is income.
Tune in to the Retirement Income Program right here every Monday morning at 11.
Forbearances, working remotely, internet shopping, retail space, and rental income have been hit hard by COVID. If you're looking to restructure your debt, obtain financing or equity, Commercial Mortgage can help you out. Tim Mullen at Commercial Mortgage has been providing debt restructuring services since 2003. Tim never charges a front fee and all consultations are free. Tim only gets paid if he provides you a debt workout. Looking for a debt solution or financing? Give Tim a call at 772-872-6099 or visit CommercialMortgageLLC.com to schedule your free consultation.
Do you have a suggestion for the show? Send us an email, WSTUMorningShow@gmail.com. And now let's get back to the Get Up and Go show. Here's Evan and Bonnie.
If you want to show off how much you like to party,
I got this.
Get a tattoo at Cliché Ink.
Good idea.
Cliché Ink has tattoos that were popular back when new episodes of Friends were still playing in prime time.
Can I get another beer, please?
Right here.
Want to show people how deep you are? Get yourself a nice tramp stamp, complete with Chinese symbols that translate roughly to drunk bohemian. Or maybe it says leaky bottoms, I forget.
This is my first tattoo.
Cliché Ink. The early 2000s are back, baby.
But I'm good. I want this. Is it going to hurt?
And let's get your eyebrow pierced while you're at it.
Time now is 8:50 on the Get Up and Go show. Let's join back in with G and Bonnie.
Trying not to cry.
Okay, I see the eyes watering right now.
Because, okay, so I would stick up for Lori when we were little kids.
Mm-hmm.
So I was really missing her the other night. I mean, I'm just like, I'm missing her, you know. I miss that smile. I miss my friend. I had a dream. So in the dream, okay, so Lori was so smart, she had already become a doctor, right? Really, she was so smart, she could have been anything she wanted. Mm-hmm. In my dream, I was back in school, but in walks Lori, all grown up. She was wearing the nicest jeans, the nicest jean jacket. Mm-hmm. She looked refreshed,
yeah,
healthy, and she said, "Hi, Bonnie." She smiled, and I was like, Lori's our new superintendent, or Lori is our principal. Mm-hmm. That in my dream, I incorporated it like Lori is here now. We're back in school, but she's in charge.
Yeah, exactly.
She's the principal.
Not Charles in charge, but Lori in charge.
Lori in charge.
That's cool, Bonnie.
And, yeah, the dream, it was just like, wow, you know, I was needing to see her. I was needing something from her. Mm-hmm. And there she showed up as the high school principal.
Yeah, well, that's good to share with this moment because we're doing nice things that people have done for folks. In fact, the last Salem witch was pardoned last week by the state of Massachusetts. Her name was Elizabeth Johnson, Jr. She was sentenced to death 329 years ago in 1693. The governor back then stopped the execution, but she was never cleared of the charges until now, 329 years later.
Really?
A group of eighth graders made it happen by researching what the state had to do to officially pardon her.
Wow. That gives me goosebumps right there.
One other one, Bonnie. After the tragic school shooting in Texas last week, there was another tragedy. The husband, and we all know this story, the husband of one of the teachers who was killed died of a heart attack just days later.
I know.
And their family is now rallying around their four kids, and so is the whole world. Someone started a GoFundMe to make sure that at least don't have to worry about money. Last we checked, $2.7 million was raised.
Really?
Wow.
Good, man. Talk about a good story on a National Smile Day. We got to end with that, Bonnie.
Absolutely right there. Thanks for sharing that one, Mr. G. At 8:52 this morning, we're looking at a 10-year-old Florida fifth-grade student has been arrested after making a school threat. Sheriff's officials said investigators learned of the threats made by the boy on Saturday and arrested him. Lee County Sheriff Carmine Marcino said in a social media post, "This student's behavior is sickening, especially after the recent tragedy in Uvalde, Texas," the sheriff said. Marcino said that making sure our children are safe is paramount. According to the sheriff, investigators learned of a threatening text message sent by the boy who attended Patriot Elementary School in Cape Coral, which is near Fort Myers on Florida's Gulf Coast. The FDA and CDC are investigating a hepatitis A outbreak possibly linked to organic strawberries. According to the agencies, the outbreak could be connected to two brands of the fruit that were sold at several retailers in the U.S. and Canada. They say Fresh Campo and Heb-branded strawberries purchased between March 5 and April 25 should not be consumed. The strawberries were past their shelf life and sold at retailers nationwide, including Walmart, Aldi, Kroger, Safeway, Trader Joe's, Sprouts Farmers Market, Heb, Weiss Markets, and Winco Foods. There have been 15 cases reported in California and one case each in Minnesota and North Dakota. At least 17 illnesses and 12 hospitalizations have been recorded so far. And thousands of flights across the U.S. were canceled this holiday weekend, causing chaos and major headaches for air travelers. There were a few cancellations at Palm Beach International Airport, but at Fort Lauderdale in Miami, more than 100 flights were scrubbed, leaving many passengers stranded. On our highways right now, I-95 southbound in Port St. Lucie, there is an accident. It's a vehicle crash at mile marker 114. And it doesn't look like there is any roadblock from the moment from that accident. When you see something, say something. Give us a call at 340-1590.
Attention growers, you have an important decision to make. The Citrus Research and Development Foundation wants a 3 cent per box levy on your fruit to fund their activities. Are your groves better off now than they were 10 years ago? Has CRDF done anything to help your groves after spending over $180 million to save your groves from citrus greening? Don't throw your good money at an organization that does nothing for you. Just say no when the CRDF asks you for the 3 cent per box levy. Paid for by the folks at SaveCitrus.com.
What is your quality of life? The Owen Insurance Group plans on improving it on our Quality of Life radio show Tuesday mornings at 10 on both WPSL and WSTU. Hi, I'm Gary Owen of the Owen Insurance Group. Along with Tom Bouvier, we'll help you on the road of life and make it a better one. Don't forget the Quality of Life radio show Tuesdays at 10 on WPSL and WSTU on TuneIn and Alexa.
Bonnie, you got any back in the days?
We do have back in the day. And, you know, just as we bring this up right here, I had one I think that I looked at earlier that I wanted to bring up. 17 years ago in 2005, Christian Slater was arrested for grabbing a woman's buttocks.
Say what?
What?
On the street of Manhattan.
What, he just reached out and grabbed? Dude. He just overcame himself. He lost his mind, just felt a lady's butt in public. Come on,
interesting.
Bonnie.
He was arrested for it.
Sure he was.
I mean, well, you know, I wonder if the woman... I don't think the lady probably was too stirred or shaken over it.
Well, she should have been.
After all, it was Christian Slater.
I know, but see, that's the difference. See, that if the perfect stranger grabbed her butt, but she would be mad. But if a star, if Brad Pitt grabbed her butt, she wouldn't be mad. I mean, come on, lady, make up your mind here.
Not right.
Either butt grabbing is bad or it's good. I mean, you can't pick and choose here who grabs your butt.
If somebody grabbed yours, who would you want that someone to be?
Not me.
No, but come on. If you're gonna, if that doesn't faze you because it was a star, you got a problem.
You know. I want to mention this one. In 1990, Seinfeld debuted on NBC.
Oh, I love that theme song.
32 years ago, and it took a few seasons to take off, but it's now regarded as one of the greatest TV shows of all time.
Bonnie, those were not nice people.
But you know what? Gee, I saw something on Saturday that was really, really cool. Seinfeld has this show on called Driving in Cars.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Out for Coffee with Comedians.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I loved it.
I didn't realize how bad the whole cast of Seinfeld was until their last episode when they showed everything that they had done to people. I'm like, damn, those people weren't. I mean, they really were. I mean, when you think about it, it's like they were not very nice people. And Jerry and his little deals with the woman with the man hands and all this stuff. But it was a very funny show.
Oh, yeah. Very well written. Very well acted. You can't go wrong with that. Let's see. Oh, 1998, Jerry Halliwell, a.k.a. Ginger Spice, confirmed that she was leaving the Spice Girls 24 years ago, and then the whole world felt it that day.
Oh, say with your mom, and your mom, and the thing, and the mom, and the
thing. Gosh.
Who's that Spice that's, Posh Spice? She's married to David Beckham, right? What a lovely couple they are.
I just love this song, though, man. I mean, can I play this? Here.
No, go for it.
Say with your mom, and your mom, and the thing, and the mom, and the thing, and the mom, and the thing. Oh.
Yo,
did any of your kids, like your daughters, get into the Spice Girls?
Oh, my.
Or
probably. I don't remember.
Sort of thing. I don't really remember getting into them too much. I knew that song that you just heard.
But, the 90s.
90s was a good era. And speaking of good era, the era of this show comes to an end just for today only, we'll say. That's a wrap for us. We are done. We are out of here. We'll be back tomorrow morning with more great stuff for you right here at WSTU Stewart, Martin County's Heritage Station. Remember, if you have good values on the inside, you won't look for validation on the outside. Make it a great day, folks, and we'll see you back here tomorrow morning bright and early at 6 a.m. Bye-bye for now. Mm-hmm.